Bank of Melbourne, the AFL Pie, Big M, and Energex. From the Sydney Cricket Ground, it's the Swans and the Western Bulldogs. Two teams with finals aspirations. Two teams with a burning desire to be there in September.
And good afternoon, everybody, from the Sydney Cricket Ground. It's a beautiful day here. Both teams beaten last week. Good form going in, though. Five out of the last seven, the Bulldogs have won with one draw, and six out of the last eight, the Swans. But I think the defeats last week add to the intensity of today's match. A couple of changes. Stevens comes in for the Swans, and Bomford's come in. We believe he's replaced Jude Bolton. And the ins for the Western Bulldogs, Hudson, Cook and Liberatore. When we take a look at the ladder, we see the importance of today's match. The top two and top four spots are very, very vital towards the end of the year. Both these teams can make a drive, particularly towards the top four. Whoever wins today between the Bulldogs and the Swans.
The 1999 AFL Coca-Cola Premiership season, proudly brought to you by Telstra, making life easier. The McDonald's Footy Burger, the double quarter pounder with cheese. Foster's Light Ice for extreme refreshment. And the new Mitsubishi Magna 3.5, the next generation.
Well, the Bulldogs in the last couple of years have struggled on this ground. There have been big build-ups in 97 and 98, but they've travelled beautifully this year. They've won three of their four games outside of Victoria. I feel as if I'm being besieged today. I've got Dougie and Terry, and I've also got Richard down below. Terry Wheeler and Dougie Hawkins, welcome.
Good on you, Bruce.
Good afternoon, Bruce. Hawk, how are you, matey?
Good, Wheels. What an absolutely fantastic game it's going to be, Wheels. As Bruce just said, both sides lost last week, and I'm looking forward to the contest with Tony Lockett down at full forward. I think Matty Croft may get that job, Wheels, and I just reckon both midfields are pretty even too, Terry, at this stage.
And what's impressed me, Hawk, is the way the centre of the ground has come up. After watching it last weekend, you were up here, it was very heavy, but very boggy, but the ground staff have brought it back up into very good condition for what is an important game. When you're talking 6th versus 7th, there's a lot at stake when you're in the bottom half of the top 8.
I say besieged because I'm surrounded by those Western Bulldog coaches and players and everything else. There's Liver. Oh, let's hope that he has a terrific match in his game back today. Richard Osborne, who played the... Well, he didn't just play for Footscray, did he? He played for a few games over the... a few teams over the... Richard, what a beautiful day we've got. Big, big match this one, mate.
That is a big match, Bruce. And one of my mates jokingly said yesterday maybe they're playing for the Richard Osborne Cup because I represented both teams. But I'm actually dressed in thermal underwear underneath. I was expecting a cool day, so it is very, very warm at ground level, Bruce. The conditions of the ground, as Terry said, there's been a lot of rain this week. It's fairly heavy at the right-hand side of the ground, right of screen, and to the left of screen in both goal squares. But overall, the ground is in good nick. Very important game for both teams. I'm going for the Dogs. They're both very disciplined teams, but I just think the Dogs are going to win this one. They need to.
Fair enough. Looks an even money bet. Lockett's had very good matches against the Bulldogs in recent years. It's been a long time since he's been kept goalless. 101 consecutive matches, and he'll be a key. Scotty Wine getting back will be important, won't he?
There's no doubt about that, Bruce, at all. Matthew Croft's the most appropriate person there, but here's a key to the Western Bulldogs side down at the other end. Paul Hudson returning after a couple of weeks out with a hamstring injury.
So the Swans kick to the left of screen on this perfect day in Sydney. Hope you enjoy the telecast. A big day of footy around Australia, and this is a big match. Goods goes against Darcy. Brad Johnson gets the first kick of the day, a floater. Wayne Schwoss keeps his eye on it and delivers to Nix on the run, who attacks so brilliantly from halfback. Plug of the target. Croft made front position. Southern's got hold of it. He's got a bit of time to come across the ground. Darcy's made the space. Kelly goes with him with Johnson. Garlick, gee, the players are going to enjoy the sun on their backs today. There's no doubt about that towards the line. O'Loughlin brings it back inside the 50. Maybe for Dimatina. No, taken by Robbins, who played a beauty last Friday night against the Bombers. He kicks the ball to centre wing. Rowan Smith, who's been kicking goals left, right and centre in the last couple, arches his back, bends his back, does it beautifully to Johnson, breaks the tackle, on the up to Liver, goes back to Montgomery. Exciting stuff at half forward, kicks to the pocket. Luffy had an airy. Chris Grant goes to ground. They attack him hard. Seymour, it's terrific to see him back after what happened to him last week. Johnson again, little kick forward by him towards the pocket. Luff gets back. It's going to be a hectic afternoon, Terry.
It is open at a frenetic pace here. The Swans right into the forward line. Then it's the Bulldogs' turn. Goods doing the ruck work. Luke Darcy running with him today. Goods, who was so good last week, some 16 disposals. Sets up Bomford, a late inclusion into the Swans lineup. Out wide. Lewis can't trap it. Cameron right there with him. The bounce doesn't favour either player. Southern comes in. Both Bulldogs go down. Lewis stays upright. Carey in the second time for the Swans. A strong tackle. Thumped to the ground by Southern. And the ball will be bounced right on the 50-metre line.
Yeah, Terry, some midfield matchups here. Scotty West is running with Creswell. Brad Johnson on Kelly. Wayne Swass has been picked up by Libba. And it looks like young Robin has got the job on the dangerous Stuart Maxfield.
Stephen Carey against Southern just takes the ball. Wild handball by Barry out into space. Scotty West gathers it, spins it on the left foot, back towards the wing. Grants the target, props in front, can't quite get to the contest. Waiting behind, Montgomery feeds off to the run of Johnson again, kick into the pocket. Cook's out clear, can't find the handle on the footy. Dunkley charges through, takes it, tackled well by Cook. And a boundary throw in this time inside the 50 for the Bulldogs.
As you caught it there, Terry, Dunkley has got the job on Cook back in the side after missing a couple of games. And Matty Croft, playing his 100th game for the Western Bulldogs, has got Tony Lockett.
Yes, there's a few milestones, Dougie, today. Creswell's a little handball. Johnson, Kelly over the top. Well done, Kelly. Stood up for it and then kicks the ball to centre wing. Barry with courage. Ooh. Kept his eye on it. Southern was there. And also Carey, Dent playing his 100th. Croft his 100th. Montgomery his 50th. All for the Bulldogs. And John Stevens, his 50th. What a remarkable career he has had with all the problems for the Swans. Centre wing, Darcy. Goods gets over the top. Johnson. Back to Goods, brilliantly done to Kelly, to Stevens, strolls inside 50 and floats it away, just floating for a behind. A good build-up. Swans have been notoriously slow starters at this ground, particularly this season, and they won't want to give a side of the quality of the Western Bulldogs any sort of a lead.
Yeah, certainly, Bruce, no doubt about that. And John Stevens probably should have kicked that goal. He's only 25 metres out running directly into the goals there. You just got to kick those goals.
Croft comes out towards Pretty up in front position on Lewis. Spoils to the ground. Dimatina. Forward handball. Cameron back off to Crediuk. 27 years of age today, Stephen Crediuk. So happy birthday to him. And the boos go up. Guess who's got it? Libba. Back from 3 weeks off. Straight into centre half forward. Bounces through the pack. Dunkley again charges the ball down. Bounces over the top of Dimatina on the near wing. Playing it on out in front. Crouch. Handball goes to no one. It's a free kick in the back. Back here to Crouch. At half forward. Swans now with their second chance. There's a man on free in the pocket. Goes towards it's Kelly. Libba gets back there. As Schwartz couldn't take the ball. Liberatore works and pushed on out. Lewis to Lockett. Lockett on over the top. Swans surely match him. Did he get his foot to it? Right on the line he has.
Offhand behind the opportunist McLeod, open goal and he's got it.
Silvani takes the field.
Hot game, cool pie.
It's the only one with sauce.
The AFL pie.
It's interesting, Dougie. Does represent a barometer for them, doesn't he, Maxfield? Ooh, when he's on target and on song and gets plenty of it, then you reckon the Swans win most of their matches. Taken by Goods. What a talent he is. Kicks the ball inside 50. Carey getting onto it for the Swans. They look sharp very early. It's a poor handball though. Taken by West. West onto the left foot. Out wide. Finds Johnson. Gee, he's having a terrific start to this game. That kick just waiting there for Curley. And O'Loughlin able to get over the top and belt the ball to the line. Richard Osborne down there with the Swans bench, Richard.
Yes, Scott Russell, Ryan O'Connor, who actually started on the ground, but as soon as the ball was bounced, Andrew Dunkley replaced him, Daniel McPherson and Nick Fosdyke.
Thanks, Rosie. I think the stability of both these teams is important. They've got so many blokes out there that have played every game this year, and the Bulldogs in particular have got blokes that have been playing for 3 and 4 years without a break. No wonder they're going well. Grant's little kick was quite clever, actually, to get it inside the 50 in the end. Hudson's handball just at the back of Smith. Comes back. Back turn was good. We know how far he can kick the footy under pressure. The handball back. Montgomery. Nearly took too long, but he was good in the end. Found Darcy at centre-half 40. Hurled it up Montgomery. Refused to panic. Late tackle coming in. Didn't put the kick off. And Darcy's marked.
Yeah, good build up there by the Western Bulldogs. And Rowan Smith is a very important player for the Western Bulldogs. Can go back and certainly can play forward. We saw him last week kick 5 goals for the Doggies and was a good player up in their forward line. But I just think today with Smith, you need Smith, Johnson and, of course, Scotty West to really fight today for the Western Bulldogs.
He can kick a goal, this fellow. He's kicked from just inside the 50. Man on the mark. Goods is at about 40 to 45. So Darcy gets inside the 50 now. Low. He's missed it, I reckon. He'll be disappointed. So it's the Swans by a goal on this glorious winter's day in Sydney. You have to be here to experience it, and a good crowd building up.
He just seemed to try and guide that Luke Darcy. He's a lot better than he can get back, and he can kick the ball, as you said, Bruce, probably 50 or 60 metres. That was probably the difference there. Just tried to guide the ball through.
Goods gets on the end of that one. Fine young talent from Horsham in Victoria. And out towards Love, the runner Schwartz. Strong build up on the wing by the Swans. In towards O'Loughlin. Front got it. 55 metres out. Will attack the goal square. Goes long. Carey gets back there. Lockett's in amongst it. There he is. The biggest man, the strongest man, stands his ground.
What a great put up by the Sydney Swans. And I know I say this every week, but Wayne Swass, when he gets the football, just uses the ball so well. And his disposal is absolutely first class. And I just got a feeling that Michael O'Loughlin's going to be a very dangerous player in the forward line for the Sydney Swans. Simon Garlick appears this stage may have the job. There could be a bit of a mismatch in height there.
Lockett for his first. He's put it into the stand.
Every year we go to Stony Point Caravan Park. What, 12A, right next to the beach. We love it here. Dad puts on his explosive Red Hot Legends of Rock tape, full blast, and people come round to complain.
Oh, g'day, mate. The music, mate.
He reckons it's a great way to meet people. And Dad turns on the charm, and before you know it, they're dropping around every day for a chat and stuff.
Kev.
That was how we met the Ranger, anyway.
Double hopped Carlton Light Bitter. Have a good one.
Well, Peter McKenna, 120 consecutive matches, kicking a goal. Tony Lockett's closing in on him. He's at 102 now. So Pluggers out after Macca. So the sequence continues with a goal to Lockett. A little kick by Johnson. High. Bomford keeps his eye on it. That's a terrific mark against the flow. So Bomford comes wide to Barry. Gee, the Swans are impressive here. They've really taken the bit between their teeth in the early stages of this match. Good stuff. Stevens to the pocket. Lovely mark in the front by Goods. Terry and I were just pointing to his name a moment ago off camera when we went to a break. This kid has got the lot, hasn't he?
What's impressive, Bruce, is he's getting the ball in the back half of the ground, and then he's prepared to get right down again and carry on right through the centre of the ground.
He's a hard runner, Will, isn't he? He just runs very hard. And with Greg Stafford to come back in his side, what a great bonus is going to be for the Sydney Swans. I just mentioned Scotty Wine. He's on the bench, I think, at this stage. He's one player I think he'd probably come back and play that loose role in the back line.
Goods' kick is not bad. Not bad at all. He's got the lot, this kid.
When Georgia finds out about Ali and Billy's affair, words just won't be enough.
Kiss it, kiss it, kiss it. Ooh, baby. Now, honey, do you think you should? I guess you thought that nobody knew.
You and Ali having sex?
What?
Put 2 and 2 together, 69.
I think maybe we should split for a while.
Shake it, shake it, shake it up, baby.
I don't want that.
I do.
Will Ali lose it all?
I'll walk away from this table and you right now.
Monday on Seven's Ali McBeal.
Sydney with the first 3 goals. Adam Goods gets his first. 3 last week to him in the game against Brisbane. And now does the ruck work against Darcy. Nearly wins the centre bounce himself. Can't get it on past Dimatina there at the bottom of the contest, and the umpire will bounce it once again.
Yeah, I was talking to Scotty Wine to come on and play that loose play behind, as a matter of fact, to fill that hole up in front of Tony Lockett. Stephen Kriddiuk's going to be doing it this stage, and looks like Danny Savin's got the job on Stephen Kerry.
So umpire Stuart Wen bounces the ball again. Goods and Darcy, 2 young men at it. Kelly punches on out Montgomery, another early possession in game number 50 for the Bulldogs. Pushes on out wide. Johnson getting off Kelly. Handball over top towards Liver. We'll look for the 1-2. There it is. The second one back is not a good one at all. And the Sydney crowd just reminding Tony Liberatore that this is their dunghill, not
Bulldogs bench.
Yeah, Hawk on the bench, as you mentioned. Scotty Wine, the skipper, Nathan Brown, Matthew Dent and Stephen Powell. And it almost looked like there that Lipper didn't have the confidence in his own kicking ability. Didn't need to give the old 1-2 there to Jono.
I agree with you. It was a long way to go. Gee, Powell's interesting on the bench. His leg speed and ability in the midfield. You wonder if he's got the flu or something. The kick to 50. Lewis, Maxfield, Robbins. Maxfield pushes in front. The Doggies were good there. Pick up by Bonford. Hooks it under pressure. He's the late inclusion for Jude Bolton. Out on the fall.
Yeah, just talking about Stephen Power there, Bruce. Over the last 3 or 4 weeks, he's been a great player for the Doggies. But the thing is, he just runs himself that hard at half-time sometimes. He runs out a bit of petrol. And maybe that could be the reason today that maybe just saved him, maybe to come on later in the game.
Let's hope they're not 8 down at half-time. It's 3-0.
Yeah, that's true too.
Croft gets it out past 50. Darcy, good mark. And in a goal, the Doggies. Hamble was probing to Curley, who broke the tackle of O'Loughlin pretty comfortably in the end. Floats it. Front spot, Grant on his toes. Gives it off to Winmar. Winmar's left foot is very wide and not particularly handsome. And it's a long way to go. And you just wonder, Chris Grant takes a mark at 50. It's going the long way around. Nicky was always going to be under the pump on the left foot there.
Yeah,
especially out on that flank. It is very heavy out there. I'd be steering clear of that part of the ground.
Yeah, I mean, Nicky Winmar can kick both sides of the body, but on that occasion, I think Chris is better off going back, Chris Grant, and having that kick instead of giving the handball to Nicky Winmar.
13 minutes into the first quarter, the Bulldogs yet to get their first goal. And no free kick there to Rowan Smith. By Greg Scroop, adjudicating there. Says the Kelly tackle was fair and legitimate. So the ball bounced now 30 metres out. Western Bulldogs goal. They desperately need one. Here's the man to do it. Perhaps it's Grant. And he misses. Misses to the near side, Chris Grant. 15 goals, 18 now to Chris Grant for the season. Not the conversion rate he would like. It's some 47%, whereas last year is over 50. Goods does the flying from behind. Seymour. Good to see him still in the side after heavy knock last week. Creswell, they're on the outer side. This over the top, Saddington. Forward handball falls a little short of the mark. Coming through Crouch. Good pass. Lewis has got it. Well, that's the second big bull out from Sydney. The first one was on this near side when Lockett goaled from the square. Now they've pulled up some 30 metres out on the outer side with Dale Lewis to have the shot.
They're just using the ball a lot better, the Sydney Swans, with their field kick has been absolutely spot on, with the Doggies been rushing the ball forward.
Lewis, the left footer, doesn't take it out wide enough to start. Draws back into the near side, another behind the Sydney Swans.
Yeah, it looks like Wayne Swass now is changing with Stuart Maxwood on the half forward flank. Libba's got the job on Swass. He's not going to go back now. Robbins is playing on Wayne Swass, who's playing the forward line now for Sydney Swans.
Croft to Garlick. Garlick, who knows this ground very well, in short. Away goes Curley. Curley, that's not good. Luff's got it now. Lockett's on a lead. He's got Swass. He can go all the way here. Load up. 30 metres out. And goals.
Do you have any idea what happens to you in a crash when you're not wearing a seatbelt? Your body is like a pinball, bouncing off the windscreen, dash and roof. Then you're likely to collide with belted occupants, severely injuring them too. The result could be severe brain or spinal injuries from which you are unlikely to recover fully. Why would you ever get into a car without putting on a seatbelt?
Sydney have flown out of the blocks. 15 minutes into the first quarter. They have 4 goals on the board and they have all the run at the moment. Bulldogs with a chance. Johnson out of the centre bounce towards centre half forward. The big pack fly. Dunkley, without hesitation, thumps the ball 30 metres away. Creswell's on the end of it. Tosses it across the body. Great diving mark, Leo Barry. He takes him up high, he takes him down low, but he takes him. Left footer held up on the wing. Number 2 in the marks taken for the Swans. Kicks dangerously now into centre half forward. Grant's taken out of it by O'Loughlin. He does it all. Takes Grant out, takes the mark, plays onto Luff. Grant's opponent. There's an overload here, but Swans in the forward line. And Crouch bobs up in the forward pocket.
Gee, Terry, they're just using the ball a lot better than the Western Bulldogs at the moment, the Sydney Swans. That's a terrific mark here by Michael O'Loughlin. over Chris Grant. And with Grant going for that mark, his opponent was Troy Luff, who ran forward. He's given plenty of drive out of that half-back flank.
Three goals in round two to Jared Crouch. He knows where they are. He's honed that one, and that's five for the Swans.
Well, no doubt, Bruce just mentioned before, this is the start that Robin Lee would absolutely be wrapped with. I mean, five goals. You said to him before the game, you'd kick five goals in the first 15, 16 minutes, he'd be very, very happy. That's Michael Locke, as I said before. He's a very dangerous player for the Sydney Swans down that floor forward line. You just got to watch him. So good with his hands, he can take a mark, he uses the ball very well. That's certainly been the difference to both sides so far.
Well, it's a real problem now for the Bulldogs. They've had it forward enough, I reckon, to kick two or three themselves, and that's the worry. And they're five behind. Good's dominating early. Livers little kick around the body, didn't go far. Johnson attacks, got a bad bounce. It might be just one of those days. Barry gets back, he's won a free kick. Kelly, the advantage given, and Kelly kicks it out wide. The Swans will be outnumbered here. Crouch, Garlick, Montgomery bringing up the rear. Garlick will go back to Montgomery. Montgomery goes along the line, just missing targets a bit. Curley again, they wait for the ball to bounce. Johnson has had a lot of it inboard to Southern. Now he's got to attack. Southern's kicked the full forward. Again, they cough it up. Saddington could have left it for Dunkley. The ball comes out. O'Loughlin can't get free. Hudson's in there. Ball up. But again, the Bulldogs overplaying it.
And Bruce, Scotty Wine's just been on the phone. The coach looks like he's coming on.
Thanks for that, Aussie. So the captain about to come out, and they need some leadership. You know, umpires today. Grant front spot, well read by Rowan Smith, and Smith's kicked the goal. Smith's got the goal. He's a goal kicker, and he's such a vital cog in this lineup. Terry talked about his versatility earlier, and the Doggies get one.
Yeah, that's a goal they certainly need. It looked like Chris Grant was doing the ruck work inside 50 for the Western Bulldogs. It appeared his tap got across there to Rowan Smith, so good play by Chris Grant, who's got a little bit of football so far in this game. But as Bruce said, Rowan Smith is a very, very important player in the forward line for the Western Bulldogs. You think he's probably going to kick three or four goals, and of course James Cook back in is another goal kicker for him as well.
So Bulldogs get there first. Rowan Smith now 20 goals, 8 for the season. Accuracy is always with him, but that was a hot chance he was given by Grant, and up to the task. They desperately need it at the Bulldogs. They need to back it up. Swans won't give it up too easily. Pomfret, he missed the ball. Scott West down low, and Johnson couldn't take it. Here's the foot race. Maxfield with Robbins. Charged down in front there by Stevens. Good give back to Maxfield. Great kick to the top of the square. Lockett sets. Can't take it. It's a ground level again. Dogs under siege here. Working at ground level. Southern with West. A wild handball out wide. O'Loughlin. Curley tries to go off the ground when perhaps he should have picked it up. O'Loughlin does do that. Picks it up. Misses the 1-2 with Bomford. West at the back. Creswell looking to set up. Outside 50, the Swans. The kick short towards Carey. Southern spoil was good. Cameron, Curley. The Dogs can't get any flow out of the back line. Unable to clear the area here as well. It's right on the line. Crouch goes for the line. That's deliberate. The Dogs win a free kick, or perhaps they scrounge the free kick.
Doing it hard, aren't they? But at least they've got one on the board now. And they might get some momentum before quarter time. Smith's kick to set a half forward. Seymour belts away. Attacking hard, Kelly. And he got a bit lucky, I think. He was down low and he got a high one. And he's got the free kick between halfback and centre wing. Magnificent career. One of the greats. Kicks into the heart of centre half forward. Saddington attacked it hard. Grant was rather, Hudson was good enough though. Winmar's handball taken by Southern. Southern's kick wants Cook. He's a long way out and he's got it in front of Love. So Grant's on Dunkley for the moment. They might have done a swap there just for a moment or two. Cook outside 50. Missed the last couple of games. He's kicked 16 goals in 10 matches. He's too far out to score. He too, like Smith, has been very accurate this year.
He's too far out.
Yeah.
Oh, way too far out. Move the ball quicker.
He's an enigma, this fellow. He's got underneath it. He's kicked it to about 15, 20 metres. Darcy front spot. Ball at the back. There are plenty of red and whites, aren't there? Seymour comes away. Good kick to Barry. Barry looked up. Saw that he had no one really, so he's just sat on it for the moment. Got himself into a wee bit of trouble. Kicks to Creswell. Well done, though, by Scott West. That's a terrific matchup, Creswell and West. tune. They're both good players, aren't they? In the Anthony Stevens mould, the bloke that kicked that great goal yesterday.
They certainly are, Bruce, no doubt about that. And I think where the Doggies are getting beaten at the moment is in the centre square. They're just getting beaten out of the centre. The Sydney Swans are absolutely dominating the centre bounce.
So ball on centre wing, thrown back in. Crediuk drives it back towards the Dogs' centre half forward position. In front, Graham takes it. Probably paid the free kick first by against Troy Lupp. There's the holding, but then Grant good enough to be able to take it. Good body work against Luff, keeping him well away from the ball.
You've just got to get the ball very quickly in, Wills, as you said there, into Chris Grant, to give him a chance to be one-on-one with Troy Luff, because it'd be fair to say probably 8 out of 10 he'd take that mark against Troy Luff. And this distance over, now this year probably made just about stretch Chris Grant. I mean, remember he first started back in 1990, he'd kicked the ball 60 metres to drop pump without a problem, but he has struggled the last few weeks.
I think all our viewers in West Footscray and Braybrook are sitting on the edge of their seats right now. Chris Grant, 48 metres out. He's kicked. He's hit the post.
Kicked a bit, I reckon, don't you, though?
Yep, he did kick a lot better then, and at least it was post high and kicked right through the ball then, Chris Grant. And he's the player the Dogs certainly need to really fire right up for him.
Just some good signs, I reckon, for the Dogs in the last three, 4 minutes. A turnover here against the Swans. I think the Swans have overplayed it in the last little bit. That's a terrific kick. They're about to kick a goal after I say that, you'd reckon. O'Loughlin down low from Luck. This is not overplaying it. Kicks to Plugger. Got him. Well, there you go. That's a terrific build-up. That's the third one. Terry talked about one outside, one the other side. That one's right down the heart and soul of it, down the guts.
Yeah, certainly was right down the guts. A bit like a training drill, Bruce, isn't it? The kick out from full-back found Troy Luff, as I said, I mentioned before. Doing a fairly good job on Chris Grant, even though I thought Grant had a bit of football. But Tony Lockett, when you get the ball kicked like that by Michael O'Loughlin, you can't stop him. Matty Croft couldn't do a thing about that one.
And remarkable record. He's already kicked one. Round 10, 1993, is the last time he didn't kick a goal in a league football match. And that was at the Witten Oval with the Saints against Footscray. Were you two blokes involved?
Yeah, I was playing that though.
And you were coaching, Terry. So, Plugger. Oh, that is a great kick. A beauty.
Leave me alone.
We're just trying to help you, all right?
Get off!
Where did you get all those bruises from?
What happened?
I was partying. I got drunk. No big deal, okay?
I didn't ask for it, I swear. Well, it happens.
I fought, Jesus, I fought. Don't tell anyone, all right? I don't want anyone to know.
I'm sorry, mate. I have to.
All Saints, Tuesday on 7.
Lockett has two. Sydney have six. The Dogs have one. This is the critical area. Centre bounce of Sydney have been so good in this area. Up to date. Wines on the ground now, but Sydney win it again. Up the half forward. Crediuk in front of Stevens. Handball under pressure. Good enough to West. Straightens it up with another one. Garlick. Some run from half back. Winmar should give it off to Johnson on the outer side. Does do that. Holds the ball up, tosses up now towards centre-half forward. Darcy's the one that has to go, but it's all Swan. Luck just floating across the front of the pack. Now across to Kelly. There's a heap of them out here. Jared Crouch has popped up out on that outer side again. He now towards the top of the square. Lockett from behind, won't reach this one. Crediuk in front. Ball at ground level, they all dive upon it. Holding it up, umpire Mark Nash will bounce it.
Yeah, I just thought the kick from Brad Johnson was probably the right option. Now, I had Cook lead into a pocket, but I think the option was to go to Chris Grant. But then again, the Sydney Swans, they can just punish you when you turn the footy over. They've done it so far in this first quarter, four or five times.
Wine misses the body on Goods. Goods takes the ball. Works with O'Loughlin, the two Koori boys together. Here he comes again. Just watch this, ladies and gentlemen. Wheels around, tosses it in. Lockett's caught behind, Croft in front. Down to Lewis, tries to dribble on the ground.
That touch of man. Most guys there were trying to kick the ball nice and hard, maybe even really post high. There's that Adam Goods again. It's been terrific so far in that contest against Luke Darcy. You'd say Goods certainly in front. And there's Dale Lewis just rode it beautifully. I don't know that the kick was that great.
Give it to him, Dougie.
Well, anyway, the goal. And they've had six goal kickers to Sydney Swans. They've been absolutely fantastic. Being that centre bounce, they absolutely give the Doggies a touch up in there.
They're flying away. After I said the signs were good for the dog, for the Bulldogs about 5 minutes ago, you knew it happened. 7-2 to 1-3. This is a onslaught at the moment. Wine to Cameron, and when he ran into Garlic, that's how well they're going. Back to Southern, back to Garlic, back to Wine. Gee, it's hard work. Back to Southern. Southern's kick, he wants Winmar. Seymour, Winmar worked to the front. Here's an opportunity. Terrific stuff by Maxfield. Wanted it a bit more, I think, than the opposition just on that occasion. Nix holds up Dimatina. Gee, Nix took it a free kick. Someone came in pretty badly there, I felt. I think Nix will get a free kick.
Yeah, I think it might have been Nicky Winmar coming late there, Bruce, but you called it absolutely fantastic, Bruce, down there. The dog is just overusing the football. They had five or six handballs. You got Chris Grant down to centre-half forward. Get the ball in there very quickly to him. Don't muck around with it.
Good transfer of play to Bomford. Bomford runs away from Cook. Has to have another bounce now. Carries provides a Sheffield. The Bonford wide. Lewis being held on to. No free kick. Crouch getting plenty of it out at half forward. Hooks it back to full court. O'Loughlin. Well, it's not a bad place to be in the front, is it? Front spot.
Well, you've got to be in front. You've got to play in front and you're a forward. And Michael Lock on that occasion certainly had did that. And Todd Cooley's got his hands full so far just in this game. Lock has been dangerous. And he's only had to kick the goal yet, but he's got plenty of football in that half forward line.
What's their record first quarter score? We might have to look it up.
I've got it at 7-4, around 10 just this year against Collingwood earlier on. So good start, so they'll better their best from this year, Bruce. Yep. I mean, they've just been so impressive the way they've moved the ball.
Well, not an easy kick, but the way they're playing, you'd reckon he's a certainty. He's been in terrific touch, O'Loughlin, today. Measures it. Well, never mind. It's another one. So 8-goal quarter.
Here's what Australia's leading motoring journalists had to say after testing the new Magna 3.5 V6.
Magna Sports is now quick enough to make plenty of hot Holdens and fast Fords look at best pedestrian.
Mitsubishi has a head kicker.
Mitsubishi has built a V8 killer.
Magna 3.5 V6 feels like a V8. See it at your Mitsubishi dealer now.
It is Mitsubishi.
Sydney continue to march on at the SCG. Sunday football on Channel 7. 8-1. Bulldogs under siege, particularly here in the centre bounce. Kelly flicks it back the other way. Robbins steals it for the Bulldogs up towards the square. They sit from behind the Dogs. The Swans are in front. Dunkley does enough to get a fist to it. Cook has a chance to open the line. He's hit the post. But the pressure from Andrew Dunkley was enough there to put the pressure on Cook. Couldn't emulate what Dale Lewis did on the other end.
Yeah, great smother here by Andrew Dunkley. Desperation. I think it was Nix as well there, Terry, at that occasion. They both dived onto the ball. There you sit it, you're right. Dale Lewis kicks the goal. James Cook misses the goal there.
Wayne Schwoss. Very good player for the Swans. Been their best couple in five of the last seven games. So he's on fire. And now big Stephen Carey's on fire. The absence of Stafford. Needing to do a lot of the big man work and does it. Saddington, good young player. The run of Maxfield. Robbins does the running. Good chase from Robbins. Maxfield's kick. It's a beauty. Lewis couldn't quite handle the hot potato. Robbins back. West. Handball on over the top. Dogs under pressure. They need a kick to clear it. They can't do it. Maxfield forward handball. Curley towards the line. He'll want the line. He can't get it. Kelly wants to keep it in. Schwoss it is. There's two players down in the shadows. Robbins, one of them.
Just the pressure rules of the Sydney Swans and the Western Bulldogs have been absolutely fantastic. I mean, they're 100 impacts and they just put enormous pressure on the Dogs.
Carey from in front position down to Liberatore. Works with Curley. Johnson, the Dogs have a chance from the wing.
Had plenty of it, Johnson. Neat kick to Smith. Well done, Nix. Smith claims the mark and paid, I think, at 50. So deep into this first quarter. Smith, thumping kick on the run. You give him some hope even from this angle and this distance, but surely not. He's going to centre it, pop it up, wants a big mark, maybe Cook, couple of big flies, ball comes to ground. Creswell looks up, has time. Fantastic opening quarter. The best ever by South Melbourne stroke Sydney against Footscray stroke Western Bulldogs was in 1986 when they kicked 8-7 in the opening term. They've done very well today. They've kicked 8-2. They're within 5 points of their best ever first quarter score. It's a 133rd time the two teams have played one another. That tells you what quality we've seen so far in this match by this man's Sydney Swans. They were magnificent in the opening quarter. They beat 8-250 to the Bulldogs 1-410.
The company knowingly sent an inexperienced young worker into an area where forklifts were operating. As a result, she was killed. The company is convicted and fined $210,000. Mr. Davis, you have shown remorse. But as a director, you knew where she was being sent and did nothing.
No comment.
You consented. Convicted and fined $40,000.
Stony Point Caravan Park. What, 12A, right next to the beach. We love it here. Dad puts on his explosive red-hot Legends of Rock tape, full blast, and people come round to complain.
Oh, g'day, mate. The music, mate.
He reckons it's a great way to meet people. And Dad turns on the charm, and before you know it, they're dropping around every day for a chat and stuff.
Kev.
That was how we met the Ranger, anyway.
Double-hopped Carlton Light Bitter. Have a good one.
Property buyers, whether you're buying a home or an investment, the Bank of Melbourne can approve your loan on the spot, in your branch, in your home, in your office, 7 days a week. The Bank of Melbourne cuts the cost of banking.
Medallion Club at Colonial Stadium. Coming soon.
As the world changes, so does the way we think.
This technology will overcome current barriers in conducting international business.
Our dreams are now being achieved.
Now, thanks to the automatic translator, we're all speaking the same language.
Whatever you dream of achieving, you can be sure that Energex will be there with you. Today, tomorrow, and for the future.
Happy. He hasn't won as a coach on this ground since taking over the Bulldogs, and they're struggling at quarter time. The Swans getting close to their all-time record against the Dogs for an opening term. They kicked 8 goals, 2. They had 7 individual goal kickers, Plugger being the one man out with his couple. And for the Bulldogs, it was Rowan Smith. So 8-2 plays 1-goal, 4. A 40-point margin. Speaking of Plugger, name again that special one, the 1300. It's $29.95, 1800-035-665. I won't forget that day in a long, long time. That Collingwood versus Sydney day where he broke Gordon Coventry's all-time record. Well, we're just wondering up here what the Doggies could do to get back into this. Rodney Ead would be absolutely delighted. Richard Osborne's down there, and Ozzy, there must have been contrasting reports from the coaches at quarter time.
wasn't there, what, Bruce? And did I say before the game the Doggies were going to win?
I can't remember.
Geez, I don't know, mate, but it's been a long time since I've seen the Doggies losing in the hardness department. That there has been the turnovers by them, but it's just testament to the pressure that the Swans have been putting on. Stephen Powell and also Dent not starting on the ground. Now, these guys are probably the most competitive guys I've played with and hard guys, so I'd have them on. That's probably the area they're lacking. Is the game over? You know, it's a big break, but time will tell.
Yeah, that's the big question. Can they get back one step at a time, I guess? Powell has come onto the ground and has gone forward, but they've got a very interesting forward set up at the moment, the Dogs. They're all cluttered around the goal square, haven't they?
We just got too many there, Bruce. You caught it absolutely spot on there. You've got six players all around each other at the moment. They've got to open it up.
So the Dogs go to the left of screen, and they need a big second quarter here to get back into this match. Curley sets it up to half forward, and there's a number of players going for the one mark. Belted away by Stephen Carey, and a boundary throw in.
Just look at their forward line setup. Maybe with James Cook back in the side, maybe the option, maybe Nicky Wimmer in the goal square one-on-one against Brad Seymour. Even Rowan Smith, who last week we saw play one-on-one in that forward line, kicked four or five goals for the Dogs last week.
Yes, he's had a big run, Smith, in the last fortnight, goal-kicking-wise. Schwoss on his wrong leg. He gets it back only as far as Credio, he's got a lot of time, but he'll need it. Now he's got hold of it. Short to Liver. Kelly coming in hard. Is that 50? It is. Well, well, well. Gee.
It's soft, I reckon. I mean, it was in flight of the board. I don't think it should have been a 50-metre penalty.
It seemed very close to when he marked the ball, but he's got the 50. So they are renewing acquaintances in one way or the other. They celebrated.
It's just so close to call, and you just wonder whether the umpire is making a decision from a pass background. Yeah. That there is something that has occurred in the past between these two boys.
Just because they had a cup of tea together. Liver's kick, he's got it. It's a goal. It's a start they needed. Well, the replay showed Kelly coming in right as he took the mark. You couldn't score it late, could you?
Yeah, I just wasn't quite sure if that was the right decision by the umpire. But anyway, there's a lot of feeling, and looks like it might be a relay free kick here for the Western Bulldogs.
So the game's starting to spice up. Before the ball returns to the centre bounce, Simon Garlick has got a free kick at centre foot. Chips to Winmar, he's got it. Fallen short, free kick is paid.
Boy, gee, a big change over this game in 1 minute of the footy.
Yeah, well, they've got to show a bit more spirit in the Western Bulldogs. The Swans absolutely give them a good touch-up in that first quarter. Yeah, gee, I don't know about the free kick. Maybe a mark more than they might have paid it for.
So the Dogs got their first goal with Liver, courtesy of a 50-metre penalty. Now Nicky Winmar, he'll kick from right on 50. From the free kick, goes towards the line. Snuck over, it's home.
Dinner's in the oven. What's wrong?
My new accounts girl was killed at work today.
It's not your fault, is it, Dad?
There'll be an inquest. I think I'll be charged.
Well, a dramatic and controversial start to this second quarter. Now, you reckon the next 5 minutes will tell a tale here. Sydney 8-2 to 3-4. The Dogs, with a bit of fortune, have got a couple of goals in a hurry. Good's magnificent out of the centre. But just see which team makes a move in the next 5 minutes. The Swans completely on top early. Maxfield running onto it hard. Delivers, but Croft leading lock at this time. Bounces off, bad mistake. Lewis Pluckett gives a free kick away, surely. Well, no. Boy, Robbins. To wide, Pluckett just collected a cut and then gets guarded and crunches him. Gee whiz, it has spiced up a bit. Powell belts the ball to half forward, a floater. Oh, nicks it, went the wrong way for him. Smith, still with Smith, back to Grant, back turns. The handball to Dimatina. Dimatina's handball eventually gets back. Powell loads up and it's long and strong and it just missed. I think we've got a game on our hands now.
At one end, we've got big Tony Lockett staking a claim for his piece of turf. There he is here, just barges on through the pack.
Is that a free kick?
Well, if it's not against Tony, it's against the Swans. There's no doubt about that.
Maybe the advantage was given.
And then he gets up and lays another strong, hard, dumping tackle.
I think he pole-axed Dale Lewis, his own teammate as well.
Well, it's only Dale. He won't be disappointed with that.
I was.
So the Swans to the outer side, the kick in. Dunkley, he's been so very good in the first quarter.
I want 50 for the Blues.
It's out of the same spot where Tony Liberatore just gained a 50 to get the first goal. So that crowd right in the action. Barry steps on around. Left foot out towards Luff. He'll take it. Some good blocking work there from Crouch. Gives it onto the run of Kelly into the forward line. Lewis in front. Spoil from Cameron was good. Towards the boundary line. Doesn't roll over. Now it does. Just flicked over the line by Paul Kelly.
Yeah, it was a good spoil by Leon Cameron. He's got the job on the day, and it was Dale Lewis. I just thought Paul Kelly, probably the option could have went long into Tony Lockett. It was one-on-one against Matthew Croft. Looks like Luke Darcy's trying to fill that spot in front of Tony Lockett.
Paul Kelly, All-Australian captain twice. What a leader here with the Sydney Football Club. Lewis gets in on the action as well with a tackle. Maxfield, couple of flicks at the football at ground level. Can't clear the area. Scotty West down on the bottom of it. West, what a player he's become, and we think he has found the bottle that Richard Osman left in the trainer's room at the Footscray Football Club when Ozzy was out there. He looks a little bit blonder this week because Westy into the wing position. Spoiled on down, the Dogs with a chance now. Matty Robbins, the former Cats, comes inside, held on the ball, just too long, taken down in the tackle. And it's been a hallmark now of Sydney. They've come on with the tackling. They're strong, they're aggressive.
Crouch to Seymour. They're taking chances. Very clean here, out wide, good run. Coming from Nix, who attacks so brilliantly, kicks to the pocket, a beauty. O'Loughlin's in the spot to have a shot. He may give it off, but he can kick a goal from here. Improves the angle and just caresses the footy to the goal square, and it's a behind. Didn't overkick it, did he?
Yeah, sorry, Bruce. Just Matthew Nix now has really become one of the best halfback flankers in the AFL. He just gives him plenty of drive. He picks up probably, probably the second best forward for the opposition, and his disposal is absolutely fantastic, Matthew Nix.
Leon Cameron to do the kicking in, just to himself. Runs 30 metres around the boundary side, then uses his left foot. Not his natural foot, but it's probably his best. Boundary throw in, Sydney 51, Western Bulldogs 23. Dogs, the first two goals of this second quarter. Johnny Stevens on screen, back into the side for his 50th game of league football. And what a great effort. Spent time at Richmond, Fitzroy, Geelong, Collingwood, now Sydney. Bumford, left foot, half forward. Dimitina gets back, takes the mark, he's going nowhere. Leo Barry ready to hold him up now. There's some opportunity on the outer side. Smith has some space, one bounce, needs to take him on, handballs on over the top towards his other speedster in Johnson, kick wobbles into the forward line, not a good one, front man in defence, takes the mark, and James Cook is getting a real lesson here from Andrew Dunkley.
He's playing one sort of a game, isn't he? Schwartz got it to Saddington, Saddington halfback, can go on to Seymour, pushes wide, gets him, now Seymour can go down the line here, and he will. Finds his man, Kelly, and Kelly can go over the top to Carey. He's got a lot of space. Lockett wants it deep. Carey loads up, goes for goal. Plugger can't get there. That's Wine's advantage to get back. That ball was missing in the first quarter. Scotty Wine filling the hole.
Yeah, certainly, no doubt, Bruce. Scotty Wine is the guy who can do that. He's done it so many times over his career, and he must be able to do that. And just again there, the Western Bulldogs, the kick by Brad Johnson was a turnover. And I think when you're a forward, you see Mike O'Loughlin play in front. You've got to be in front. James Cook was caught behind there, and Andrew Duncan's been a very good player. I think maybe a move by Terry Wells could happen very soon, Wills, I reckon.
So Cameron's kick, still coaching up in the box, are you, Wills? This is Mark Von Johnson.
Johnson on the outer side. Garlick just held up by Kelly. Good defensive play. When teams score here at the SCG, they usually do it by carrying the ball some 100 or 150 metres on a flow. Dogs held up. Smith wants to get that run going. Over he goes. A free kick. Not being called downfield by umpire Greg Scroop. It's going back from where the kick was.
Is that the right decision there? Or should the ball go down to where the ball was kicked? Well, I'm not quite sure.
So the umpire deemed that it happened right on the kicking action. Smith and Johnson work together. They nearly make a meal of it there. Cameron from behind again on the left foot. In towards Grant. He's got it on the burst. Mark number two. two for Chris Grant. His kick is a very, very wayward.
You just look at that, and Leon Cameron's been very good in the back line today so far, and Lewis, and Cameron's got the ability to kick the ball both sides of the body, just a natural kicker on both sides. But gee, Chris Grant then missed his target by about 15 or 20 metres.
Important opportunity for the Bulldogs. Carey does it well for the Swans, being snared, kicked on over the shoulder. They've been able to pinch it. Steve.
Serious comeback now, isn't it? Three consecutive goals, 8-4 to 4-5, and the Swans have had a couple of chances going forward. Crouch, little left footer, bouncing ball, Southern's got hold of it, it's been all right, straightens it up. Johnson's had so much of it early. I wonder if he's worried by his groin. He's not kicking as well. That one did find Dipatina to Liver. Well, that's going to happen every time he touches it. He hopes they boo all day. He's at half forward, little kick to the pocket to Cook, got him, taking the mark. So the Swans are a bit frustrated here. The Doggies, slow build-ups, keeping the ball off a bit. Cook, you'd say outside his range, this would be as tough a kick as you get in AFL. From the pocket, wrong side for a right footer.
I don't think you'd get this distance, Bruce. And I just think the big turnaround this quarter has been the Western Bulldogs midfielder really worked a lot harder and been accountable for their opponents.
Doug, you call James Cook won't get this distance, and I agree. And James Cook should know this. He wasted an opportunity in the first quarter where he held on the ball on the outer side again, just far too long, and Sydney get back and swamp it all together.
Well, Lee Matthews mentioned after the match last week they felt they had an advantage with high marks in the goal square against Sydney. Felt they were vulnerable there. Let's see if someone from the Doggies can take a big one. And in fact, Carey was the man that put his hand on it. I'm sure Rodney Eade would have taken note of that comment. It's 8-4 to 4-6, but as Dougie mentioned a moment ago, you just look at the scoreboard and suddenly you think, gee, this is a different game to the one we saw in the first quarter.
Yeah, kick one or two quick ones to Western Bulldogs, they're right back in this game.
Schwartz to bring it in, so not getting enough from Cook at the moment, but who knows. Maxfield
on towards the wing position. Goods from behind. He's either Goods or not, this boy. Away he goes, he kicks a beautiful kick in towards centre half forward. Saddington takes it, away he goes, he's got space now, wobbles it towards Plugger, out he comes, can't take it on the first grab, Luff runs it down, caught in the tackle from Wine, the ball will be bounced.
Adam Goods is just freakish ability, he just jumped in front of the two Western Bulldogs players, punched the ball sort of forward, and his disposal was absolutely spot on for a big man, he's just unbelievable, he gets around the ground so easily. Can he play?
Ball will be bounced, 30 metres out from goal, Swans with a chance. Goods from behind, Wine. Wine just too tall, pushes out towards the boundary line. Defensively, as he should, Curley wants the line as well. They can't quite find what they want, the Bulldogs out there. Now it is. Boundary throw-in. Sydney skipped away, led by 40 points at quarter time. The Dogs now have pegged it back to 22. They've kicked the three goals of the quarter. Cameron concedes it on back. The Dogs under pressure across the goal face. Will run away from Southern and Saddington. The boundary throwing on the opposite side now. Danny Southern returned to the side last week. Thigh problems have plagued his career. Nick Fosdyke waiting on the boundary line. Carey gets it down. Schwass along the boundary line. Acutely in the end for a boundary thrown in front of Creswell.
I just reckon now Adam Goods is running with Scotty Wine. I just think Luke Darcy's probably the best option, particularly over the ground where Scotty probably will have problems keeping up with Adam Goods. He's so quick. It could be a move made by Terry Wallace, I think.
Fosdyke on for Stevens. Darcy read it best. Fosdyke, Dipatina. Here's Fosdyke. O'Loughlin pushing forward. Powell. Centre wing, ball to be won. Grant hard at it, couldn't quite. West held up. He hasn't had much influence yet. Scotty West has had 9 disposals, 3 kicks, 6 handballs. I'm surprised at that many. And it'll be a ball up at centre wing. 8-4 to 4-6. Terrific effort here by the Bulldogs after the Swans were outstanding. It was absolutely a brilliant first quarter by them.
Yeah, there's no doubt they've got the momentum, Bruce, but the one thing they don't need to happen is for the Swans to kick a goal.
Yep, Liver. Good play by Bomford to Creswell, to Barry, who's a natural left footer. Now Lockett goes down and Barry kicks it beautifully. Oh, that is copybook.
Well, Bruce, he caught it beautifully. I mean, the kick from Leo Barry was absolutely spot on. He had Paul Kelly leading early, decided not to go in an extra bounce, and that kick, Scotty White got in the right spot. He did everything right, Scott White, by playing that loose kick behind the player to fill up that hole, but the kick was just too good.
Pluggers kick two. He's going to kick from about 48. So, kick very confidently so far today. Oh, that's a beauty.
We're Tracy,
Matt and Jamie from the Fox Morning Crew. Love the boob job, Trace.
Well, Matt, we are giving away a trip a day to LA.
Look for the Fox to appear during one of these programs tonight on 7. Then listen to 101.9 The Fox the next day for your chance to win.
Think big prizes, think Wheel of Fortune.
A good oven, generous.
Brendan's feeling lucky.
$1,000.
Kerry's up with the winners, and the champ reckons he's another chance for the car. Wheel of Fortune, Monday, 5:30 on 7.
Perhaps the story of the game is panning out. Tony Lockett, the only multiple goal scorer, therefore could be the difference between the two sides. Goods does the ruck work for the Swans. Powell works with West, who out to Curley. Finds some room to kick from the centre square up to the forward line. It's gone wide to the pocket. Cook caught behind, Dunkley in front. Just thumps it on another 15 metres for a boundary throw-in.
He's been good, Dunkley, down there at full back. Just so reliable, tough, hard at the ball, and always gives you 100%. You always expect that from Andrew Dunkley. Never let you down.
Third and best and fairest twice with the Swans. Here's a chance now from Grant. He doesn't mind these on the boundary line. If you're going to give him a shot, give him the tough ones. He'll put them home. So Grant gets his first. The Dogs have kicked four in the quarter.
Yeah, well, just a quality play, Chris Grant. He just done that easy, made it look easy. The ball came in, he roved that like a rover, which he's not. And just Steve, and as you said, Terry, he does kick those harder goals where sometimes when he's directly in front, only 40 or 50 metres out, he has struggled to kick those goals. But that's the quality player Chris Grant is.
Bit of a shootout at the moment, isn't it? 9-4-5-6. Doggies have to keep it to about this, you think, by half-time. If they do, then they've got a real chance. Swans, 22 points up. Chris Grant will be an important player, as he always is. That's going to give him a big lift. Darcy belts it out of the centre. Bomford, a late inclusion today for Bolton. Nick's back to Bomford. It's good play. Bomford's kick wide. Carey had to stretch. Well, they messed it up there, the Swans. They had three blokes in the van. And Crouch actually took the Fosdykes running. The ball back to centre wing. Darcy on the up. Power slip, but got through the tackle from Bomford. And then straightens up and goes for goal. Not quite. It's Winmar. Paid. Well, gee, it was close to going over for a behind. Goal umpire's happy, though. And Winmar takes the mark. Well, one ex-Saints kicked three so far today. Tony Lockett, this bloke played so much of his great footy with Plugger at Moorabbin. And he's been a good pickup for the Dogs this year. At 33 years of age, about to turn 34.
Dale Lewis is just having a rest for Ryan O'Connor.
Kick this, and this match really tightens.
It certainly is. It'll take a big kick.
Well, he's such a class player.
Great.
He's happy. He's 52nd.
Monday.
I've delivered some tablets before.
This one is all heart.
I'm scared.
Seven babies.
Surprise, surprise.
Plus one.
Eight? Is that eight?
Less than a handful.
He's so tiny.
Now.
What's happening?
Cold blue duck.
They will need another miracle.
But everybody, let's get in and get out.
To save something so fragile.
He's a very sick, weak little boy.
Chicago Hope.
I just want to hold him.
Monday, 9:30 on 7.
Winmar gets his second of the quarter. Dogs edge closer still. 16 points now, the difference. They've started to win a few ball from the centre bounce. Yep. Here's another one. Darcy this time turns it around. In front is Smith. He played on with a handball when he shouldn't have perhaps. This gives Swans the chance. Big Ryan O'Connor on the ground. A little slow, feeds it on out towards himself. Fosdyke gives it over towards West. West forward over the top of Johnson now, settling from 50 towards the top of the square. The Flyers had come from behind. It's not there. Dunkley in front takes the mark. Cook just had no elevation in his legs at all there.
No, just couldn't jump then. And Dunkley has been terrific. The kick from Brad Johnson was absolutely the right option.
Nix towards Carey. Doesn't quite reach him, but it's slapped on down to ground level. Saddington, neat for a big player. The kick's a good one towards Kelly. Curly Spoil is up to the task, backing through the centre of the ground. In towards Gallagher in front. He's got it. They're peppering away out at the Dogs. Spare man out in the pocket. It's Grant, as he's seen. Tosses it up now. Grant has to go on back towards the line. There's a fly from Cook. Joel umpire has a good look at it. Either way, it's a goal to the Dogs. Don't worry about it. Garlick gets the goal. Cook ever so close. But the Dogs keep coming. Six goals in this second quarter.
Yeah, good goal by Simon Garlick. He played a lot of footy, of course, originally with the Sydney Swans, since crossing across the Western Bulldogs. Curly, good football by him too, to turn that ball from the pass from Paul Kelly. Simon Garlick had a couple of teammates, certainly in a short option there, but he does this ground very well. He's gone back and kicked the ball 50 metres, so it's a very good goal. It's going to be a shootout here.
What a remarkable change has come over this match.
And Bruce, you think back to that West Coast Eagles-Bulldogs game there. It was last year.
Eight goals in the first quarter and then eight in the second.
Dogs turn around again, and it has similarities right.
Quality side, aren't they, the Doggies?
9-4 to 7-6. She's a magnet at that end of the ground, and the goal, she'd reckon. And the ball just keeps going down. Then Nick's got a high tackle free kick. But the Swans have turned it over in this term like the Dogs did in the opening term. Wrong options, players just getting in the road of other players. And, well, all of a sudden, we've got a terrific game on our hands here. Goods was dumped off the ball a moment ago. O'Loughlin, Bonford, Kelly goes wide. Bonford kicks it neatly to him. That's better. Well, Kelly to Swass, interesting. Don't know about that. Back to Kelly. Gee. Inside to Crouch, goes on. Oh. Cool to go on. They'll want to get a goal out of this. Wine, Saddington, back to O'Loughlin. O'Loughlin with a bit of magic, maybe. High and hard in the goal square. Croft did well. Plugger, O'Connor. The ball still hasn't come out. The ball still hasn't come out. It still hasn't come out. It still hasn't come out. It's a point.
Oh, wonderful football all round.
I tell you what, though, it wasn't a great move by Kelly to Swass.
No,
Swass back to Kelly, overcooked it.
We saw the same play earlier from the Bulldogs when Grant gave one off to a player running wide as well.
Rowan Smith.
Yeah, Winmar. They forced themselves too wide. No, more direct play there, but now it's with the Bulldogs. Cameron's kick didn't quite reach Predio. Under pressure. No respect for his birthday there at all here from Sydney. They're going to make every post a hard one. Every ball that's to be won in this contest is going to be well earned. And there are plenty of tough men who do it in the contest. West and Creswell, what a matchup there. Liberatore, Schwoss. Here's the big men, Ryan O'Connor and Scotty Wine. They decided to do it on their knees. As a result of that, they couldn't clear the area. Bulldogs' best second quarter this year was 7 straight against Geelong.
Nathan Brown now has got the job on Michael O'Loughlin, so Todd Cooley's been taken away from him. He's playing on Leo Barry.
59 to 48, 23 minutes of play gone in the second quarter. Creswell overrun. Here's Brown. I just spoke of him. Handball to Powell. Doesn't really clear the air out. They need a kick. Oh, there's not one there. Oh, that is a thumping tackle from Barry. Too high, says the umpire. But they're out to bruise him, and Leo Barry comes again. Johnson swift enough to be able to step it. Kicks towards half forward. Grand outnumbered, outbustled. Mark can't be taken by Maxfield, but comes again at ground level. Saddington doesn't clear it. O'Loughlin. Swans under pressure in the pocket. Work it away beautifully to Schwoss on the left.
She's a hot footy at the moment. Good front spot. Taken by Dimitina. Charges away. High and hard. Cook a target. Garlick to Rover at the back. It was belted away by Dunkley. Terrific stuff. Bonford's little kick. West just couldn't quite control it. Creswell's tired and he won a free kick. Good stuff here. This is a good game of footy now, isn't it?
How's Andrew Dunkley? I mean, he's just jumped right over the top there and punched the ball 30 metres back. Wills, you're wrapped there, though, Terry.
You are, because there is just no hesitation in it. No half this or half that. When he thumps it, it goes.
Barry, a left footer.
Crouch, it sits now to Russell on the ground. Plugger, Russell goes for goal, misses, it's a behind.
Would have been the dream start by Scotty Russell, straight off the bench and almost EPI.
Well, it's 4.5 minutes to go. Fosdyke off the ground, Russell on to half-time, 9-6 to 7-6. Swans have only led in their 7 matches here in Sydney at half-time on one occasion this year. Surely they're going to be in front at half-time today. You wouldn't have put a dollar on it, 100 to 1, the Bulldogs being in front at half-time. They're still a couple behind, admittedly. And Grant's got a free kick at centre wing in front of Luck.
He does that body work well, Grant.
The advantage is given. Gee, to Credial. Players are stocked a bit. Kicks to Smith in the pocket with Nicks. That's a terrific matchup. Nicks did well on that occasion. Boundary throw in a left half forward, almost up to the pocket for the Doggies.
And
the
Matthew Dent about to come on. I heard it. Paul DiMartino there replacing.
Yeah, good play there by the Sydney Swans. Both defenders there just punched the ball and caught beyond. Matthew Nicks, and only a moment earlier Andrew Dunk was just terrific play by them.
Ryan O'Connor doing it all for the Swans. Did the ruck work, then the ground level work. Seymour can't get it. Johnson, he gets a handball on out. Finds Smith somehow. Smith goes looking. Can't find the target there. And DiMartino, he's heading towards the interchange bench. As Richard Osmond said, Smith's going nowhere. Free kick to the dog. Holding here. Paul DiMartino to get it. Nicks and Smith. What a foot race that'd be. And they'll be turned around here.
Surely won't.
Good umpire.
Yeah,
would have been silly, wouldn't it?
Yeah,
the umpire actually had his back to that, so he didn't see what they did.
You can't grab a man around the throat, though. DiMartino, kick, it's wide. Winmar, Seymour does it all. And DiMartino heads to the interchange bench.
It's not a cop-out. I actually didn't see him grab him around the throat. I thought they just had a little tumble together.
Yeah, I get concerned. You know, we often see those shows of aggression between players, and sometimes they do grab around the neck.
Yep.
Thumbs in on the old Adam's apple. It's a dangerous one. Anyway, boundary throw in. Half forward flank for the Bulldogs. They've kicked 6-1 in this second quarter. Leon Cameron leads the race to the ball. What's this it? It does for him. Now he's run out a bit of support. He's in a bit of trouble. Dent, the handball went out of bounds according to the umpire.
I don't know about that one.
That must have been the outswinger, was he?
That is Matthew Dent. That is sure.
Matty Dent, game number 100. Umpire Mark Nash, an experienced umpire. He's not going to take anything untoward.
Well, Ozzy was right down there, Wills. He must have had a good view of that one, Oz.
Well, from where I was, Hawk didn't look out.
Dent giving it back to the umpire. Too crudely. Powell across the body. The dog's still working in the wings and pockets. Haven't been as direct as the Sydney side. In fact, that was a criticism of the side last week, in that a lot of their possessions in the centre were taken out on wings, pushed further on out.
You're dead right, Wills, they are. They're certainly not using the ball well when they've gone inside 50. They are going to the pockets. Just got to go directly down the corridor, right down the middle.
O'Connor won it. Free kick to Creswell, surely. No advantage given. No advantage, rather. No decision. Luff's kick's terrible. He did this last week, Luffy. He kicked across the ground a couple of times and coughed it up. And Garlick, who kicked a long goal early in this quarter, can bang this home and put the Doggies within a goal.
Winmar and Seymour had a bit of a crack at each other.
Gee, hasn't this game changed in half an hour? That early, that the 50 metres from Kelly to Liver, and then the free kick in the centre without the ball being bounced, has changed the whole look of this match. The Dogs probably needed a lucky break. They got it, and they've taken advantage of it, and Garlick's going to kick it. They're within a goal. Got two.
As the world changes, so does the way we think.
This technology will overcome current barriers in conducting international business.
Our dreams are now being achieved.
Now, thanks to the automatic translator, we're all speaking the same language.
Whatever you dream of achieving, you can be sure that Energex will be there with you. Today, tomorrow, and for the future.
Future.
Sunday football on Channel 7 at the SCG. Sydney skipped out an 8-goal first quarter. The Bulldogs have bounced back with a 7-goal second quarter. Garlick has the last two of those. Good. He's back in town, running it through the centre. The direct play ends up with Preswell. Wobbles it into the forward, floats over the top of Lockett. Brown does well, slaps it back, only just clearing the line. One behind.
Adam Goods, every time he gets the football, there's just that quality about him. And the handball to Creswell, I don't know if that was probably the right option, but Creswell's not the best kick to give the ball to.
Or senior player often demands
it. Demands it, Robert. Yeah, give it to your son.
Wasn't that your last 20 or 30 kicks in league footy?
it was mine, I tell you.
From the wing, garlic again. 61-54. Approaching 30 minutes gone in the second quarter. Nix flies from behind, but there was interference against Carey. Rowan Smith to take the ball. Clock ticking down. They match the 8 goals from the Swans into the forward line. Dunkley and Cook neither could take it. Off the ground by Luff. This time it's going to just get through for a behind. No Bulldogs lurking. 6 points.
Andrew Dunkley, just that last minute lunge. I mean, he was caught behind. The kick was pretty good by Rowan Smith over to James Cook. But just that desperation by Andrew Dunkley just to push Cook there to make him score that ball. Good play by Dunkley.
6-point game here. Russell. He's kicked it close to the line, but he found Seymour at halfback. He's got Luff in short. Bomford running for him. He'll kick to Bomford now at halfback. Gee, the Swans could do with a late goal here just to give them some confidence. Barry, slow motion. Unsure. Just pops it up. Okay. Creswell was nearly off, I reckon. Had a look. Comes back off the mark quickly. Then wheels around and kicks to the pocket. Contest there with Schwoss and also Liberatore. Free kick coming to Schwoss. Is it for a high one? Is it Schwoss?
I think it's Creswell. I think Bruce.
Or Crouch, is it?
Crouch, is it?
Crouch, I think. Crouch has got it. Yeah, that was
Crouch.
High one against Chris Grant. Now, Jared Crouch probably too far out here. Plugger calling for a deep. Trying to get a run at it. They need a late goal just to give them a little cushion. And to improve Rodney Eade's temperament at half time. The kick to the pocket, not good. Boundary throw in.
Stuart Maxwell's off the ground now, having a bit of a spell, and John Stevens back on for the Sydney Swans.
And he has dried up, Maxwell, hasn't he? As have a number of his teammates. Rocket will be seething after having what looked to be almost a match-winning lead at quarter time. In fact, we sat here at the quarter time break wondering how the Bulldogs could get back into this match. Well, they've done it pretty quickly.
Yeah, good sides do it, Bruce, don't they? They can get back when they're down, and Western Bulldogs is a very quality side.
O'Connor or Goods coming in right over the top. Schwoss back towards Stevens. Stevens can't get it out. Little toe poke coming, and be a ball up. So we haven't got much time to go now. 9-7 to 8-7. Fascinating first half. It's been terrific to watch from where we're viewing it. I hope you're enjoying it around Australia on the Seven Network. Wine on this big day of AFL footy. West towards the pocket. This is one of the standout matches in round 14, and it's living up to it.
I had the pleasure yesterday, Bruce, of doing Kangaroos in Brisbane, and I had a two-pointer there.
It's
wonderful football being played at AFL level now.
Wine, O'Connor, Creswell, back to Kelly. And the Swans are going to feel as if they lost that first half. For only the second time in Sydney this year, they lead a match at half-time in 8 goes. But in many ways, it's the Bulldogs that will go in at half-time feeling as if they've taken the points. The Swans kicked 8-1 in the first term, and the Bulldogs kicked 7-1 in the second quarter. Controversial term, number of umpire decisions probably upset the Swans and their fans. But the bottom line was the Doggies made a few changes and they worked. Powell was terrific on screen there. And Smith's been important. So at halftime, it's Sydney 9-7, the Doggies 8-7.
A game.
Cool pie.
It's the only one with sauce.
The AFL pie.
The Bank of Melbourne serves you better. On Saturday mornings, when the other banks are sleeping in, the Bank of Melbourne is open to serve you better. The Bank of Melbourne cuts the cost of banking.
Win Big M's New Year competition, and you'll celebrate the new millennium in Sydney. Then cross the international date line and do it all again in Hawaii. If you thought this New Year's Eve was going to be big, imagine doing it twice.
I love the Eagles. Hey, but you know what gets me?
People like you sitting at home on your PlayStation playing footy like a loser!
Loser!
And you keep picking my team. You keep picking the Eagles! Well, rack off!
Pick another team!
I want to win! I want gold!
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 Get in the game!
What's your secret?
Stir fry with satay sauce. Fountain sauce, of course.
Flight Attendant giving you and a friend
the chance to win 10 out of 10 prizes.
You'll get to spend grand final week
with a Club 10 superstar.
We'll have lunch in Sydney
before going to the Brownlow.
Lunch before the grand final.
Then off to the big game.
And party afterwards.
Plus, you can go shopping at Mitre 10 with 10 grand to spend.
There's also fantastic weekly prizes to win.
Autographed by us.
Just watch Friday Night Footy on 7.
For 10 out of 10 prizes.
Every year we go to Stony Point Caravan Park. Lot 12A, right next to the beach. We love it here. Dad puts on his explosive Red Hot Legends of Rock tape, full blast, and people come round to complain.
Oh, g'day, mate.
The music, mate.
He reckons it's a great way to meet people. And Dad turns on the charm, and before you know it, they're dropping around every day for a chat and stuff. That was how we met the Ranger, anyway.
Double-hopped Carlton Light Bitter. Have a good one.
McDonald's McMansion with Monopoly. Now meet some of the big winners. Rachel Clark from Queensland. And the Morgan family from New South Wales. And Pat Collins from Tasmania.
McMansion with Monopoly. Stick around. This is big.
On Today Tonight, she saved her son from the bullies.
The school can't do anything. The law can't do anything.
Now she's charged with assault.
Well, what can I do? The parents aren't controlling those children.
How far can you go to stop kids being bullied?
I felt the need to pay another child just to make sure that my kids were okay.
Plus, your beauty budget may never be the same. Cheap cosmetics versus expensive.
You don't necessarily have to buy the most expensive brand.
And is this Australia's most sexist boss? This week...
On Today Tonight...
Oh, what a remarkable game here in Sydney. If you look at it there, you say, gee, it's been close all day. Well, it hasn't. It was 8-1 at quarter time. It's now 9-7-8-7. Lockett, the standout in terms of the goals. And Winmar and Garlick, second quarter goals for the Bulldogs. Oh, Dougie, it's been a strange old game. There's been so much to have a look at. Adam Goods has been as good as anyone out there, hasn't he?
What a great talent he is, isn't he? I mean, he just used the ball. He gets around the ground so well for a big fella. That was a bit of a problem with Scotty Wine, the matchup there. I just thought Luke Darcy was the option, which Terry Wallace went with. But the move was maybe Scott Wine to come on and just fill that gap in front of big Tony Lockett. And here he is, Adam Goods once again. I mean, he's just a terrific young talent, and particularly when Greg Stafford comes back into that side, it's going to be a great, well, probably a bit of a problem, but not really a problem. It'd be fantastic for Ronnie to have him get back in the side as well.
Well, you reckon he could play as a key forward or key defender. He is so good. Plugger's been pretty good, hasn't he? I mean, he's kicked 3 goals so far, and they were on fire early.
Yeah, they certainly were, no doubt about that. He's a very, as we know, dangerous player down there, Bruce. Just one-on-one, he's a very hard man to match up with, and Matthew Croft playing his 100th game. He's done a pretty reasonable job. You know, Plugger's kicked the 3 goals, but, you know, they probably only had an opportunity on 4 or 5 occasions to play that opportunity to play one-on-one, so Lockett's been absolutely fantastic, those 3 goals. And the thing about, too, Bruce, Sydney have had 7 goal kickers, and the Western Bulldogs had 6, so the ball's been shared around by their forwards. But I just felt in the second quarter, the Western Bulldogs midfield started to work a lot harder. Here's Leo Barry. He's had a pretty reasonable game. That kick was absolutely spot on because Scotty Wine was in the right spot there to block the big fella. And this bloke just doesn't look like missing. He's just a terrific player.
He's kicked so beautifully, hasn't he? And we've seen 2 of the 3 goals. He has not looked like missing so far today. Dale Lewis kicked a freakish goal in the first quarter. I was probably pretty kind to him, Dougie. He may have half-fluked it, but he is such a talent.
Well, he certainly is. He got right in the right spot for a forward pocket, right in front of the big fella Plugger. The kick rolled about 4 or 5 times, Bruce, and went through, but that's the quality of Dale Lewis. He can do those sort of, I suppose, special things at times.
There's been a key moment in this match. It's the Kelly 50 metres on Liver. This is the first minute of the second quarter. It was all one-way traffic until this point. Now, bang!
I don't really agree with that, Bruce. I think the umpire, in my opinion, got that wrong. I just thought the Liver just marked the ball. Paul Kelly made that contact. I wouldn't have gave the 50-metre penalty. I don't think that was the right decision.
Stephen Powell sat it out early, which was a bit of a surprise, I think. This was a set play from a throw-in where he goaled.
Yeah, it was. He sort of made something out of nothing, Stephen Powell. As you said, started on the bench, and I just reckon over the last 5 or 6 weeks, he's probably been one of the best Western Bulldogs players because he just runs himself so hard. And there's times at half-time, he's running that hard, he's that tired, he can't keep going after half-time. He's been a very good player in that second quarter.
Terry Wheeler said in the call, give Chris Grant the hard ones, he may kick this one. Well, he did just that. He's had plenty of it, Grant, and could still be the match winner.
We certainly could be, and Troy Luff, I think, has done a pretty good job on Chris Grant, and Grant's got the ability to do that, but Troy Luff, that kick across the goal, you know, and found a Western Bulldogs play, the turnaround certainly cost the Swans.
Well, it's really set up now for a fantastic second half, so whoever you picked at the start of the match, I reckon you'd stick with them and keep your fingers and toes crossed. Now, the Under-18 Championship is being played in Brisbane at the moment. Division 2 result, New South Wales ACT defeated Northern Territory 20 goals 22 to 7 goals 11, and Queensland played Tasmania as well, also in Division 2. That was much closer. Queensland 10-13 over Tassie 9-11. Vic Metro in South Australia has been put back because of the condition of the ground. So they're the results so far from the AFL Under-18 Australian Championship. We'll be going shortly to Adelaide for a preview of the Crows and the Cats after this break.
McDonald's McMatchin with Monopoly.
Now meet some of the big winners. Rachel Clark from Queensland. And the Morgan family from New South Wales. And Pat Collins from Tasmania.
McMatchin with Monopoly.
Stick around. This is big.
How does it happen? You're racing a fuse or printing the news. And you strain till you think that you'll burst. You sure got a thirst. A hard-earned thirst needs a big cold beer. And the best cold beer is Victoria Bitter. It can come at any time. You're taking a vow or chasing a cow. Matter of fact, I got it now. Victoria Bitter.
Where are my socks? If I don't get those socks, I'm out of business.
Did you check all your stocks?
There's no socks in my stocks.
Check down by the docks.
I'm the docks. It's no socks.
I've checked every box. There's no box full of socks.
Forget about socks. I just saw a fox.
We got locks.
We got frocks.
Not frocks, not walks, not locks, just socks.
You have got your clocks.
Supply chain problems? IBM has internet solutions.
Sure, blame the Scots.
A lot of people want to look beautiful. Mike Jackson, Pamela look like many operations I do. But this special request, he love Finn's chips so much.
I help.
Okay, time take look. Nurse, unwrap, please. Now, we check Finn's. Operation, big success. Happy ending!
Finn's, cut thin to fit more in.
Hi.
Listen, I'm really sorry about what happened. Is there anything I can do to help get your car back on the road?
We're with Amy. They're taking care of everything.
Quotes?
Done.
Repairs?
Done.
Good quality?
Guaranteed for the life of the car, even if I sell it.
Oh, wow. Well, I guess you don't need me then. Have a nice day.
A free service that takes care of all your post-crash running around. Call Amy now. You're with Amy.
Here's what Australia's leading motoring journalists had to say after testing the new Magna 3.5 V6.
Mitsubishi has a head kicker.
The silky 3.5 engine matches Commodore's output and outstrips it in power to weight.
Mitsubishi has built a V8 killer.
Magna 3.5 V6 feels like a V8. See it at your Mitsubishi dealer now.
Game.
Cool pie.
It's the only one with sauce.
The AFL pie.
Welcome back to the SCG. You'd think there was a howling breeze blowing here, but the flags are hardly fluttering. I can tell you that. And Sydney at half-time lead 9-7 to 8-7. A remarkable first half. They led by 40 points at quarter time, and it's down to 6 points. Well, if it was the Crows and the Cats after round 5, we would have had two heavyweights. They were both going great guns at that stage. They've been in a bit of a hole. There's a big game today. Drew Morford's there to call the action. Drew, they both need to win to stay in touch.
They sure do, Bruce. It's a funny old season, isn't it? They're 13th and 14th on the ladder, both with records of 5 wins and 8 losses. And, of course, the Cats' 8 losses have come in the last 8 rounds. And with a drop in percentage from about 124% to about 92, that's virtually a game. So they might have actually lost 9 games in 8 rounds. Nearly impossible. John Platton's with us today. Changes in both teams. The Cats have made 6, 5 of them unforced, so they're really throwing them around. And once again, the Crows are weakened by suspension and injury.
Well, they sure are, Drew. You know, with Bickley, Robin and Smart out, it makes it fairly difficult for the Crows. It's sort of a side which you haven't seen. Well, it's not their best side out on the ground, but certainly it's one of these games where whoever wins today has got a big chance of playing in the finals. Well, here, if they lose, that's it.
Absolutely. Well, here are the Cats arriving, and just their confidence must be at rock bottom. How do they get out of this slump? 8 losses in a row. But, of course, the Crows are struggling as well. And has the miracle been averted? Well, Blighty said so last week, but there's still only 1 game in percentage outside the 8. Let's have a look at the changes. Downsborough, McGregor comes in for his debut game, and Trent Ormond-Allen is also in for his first game of the year. But the skipper, Bickley, is suspended for a week. Robren and Smart with hamstring injuries. And Geelong have made the 6 changes. Unbelievable. Gary Hocking missing a couple of weeks with his knee injury, but it could finish up being the season for him. But Lindsay, Mansfield, Snell, Sanderson and Simpson all dropped from last week, so they're really struggling to find a winning combination. OK, let's go down to the Crows' rooms at the moment, and Neil Curley is down with us. Well, often we see games where we think we might be in for a poor game, but a couple of weeks ago when the Crows played Collingwood, when Collingwood bottom of the ladder, we got a ripper, so it might be the same this week, Curls.
Well, it certainly could be true. As you said, both teams are at the bottom of the scale as far as premiership ladder is concerned. Very quiet down here. The boys are just going about their preparation in a quiet manner. But I think this is Geelong's real chance to beat the Crows here. You've already mentioned Smart, Robren and Bickley out, but then you throw in Wren, Marsh, Johnson, Bond and Eccles. A bit of a skeleton side for the Crows today, and I think if the Cats can go about this in the right manner, they could well chalk up a win here.
Yes, I think both sides would be looking for this game as one that they'd like to be playing in at the moment to get a rare win on the board. Platt's a perfect day here in Adelaide.
Beautiful.
22 degrees, and yes, the Chardonnay set is out in the members' car park. And it's just all set for a picnic, game of football, really.
Well, I was just driving here and the barbecues are out and everybody's having a few little slight little drinks, so it's been good.
But it is far more important than that. 4 premiership points up for grabs for the winner here today, and both clubs desperately need it, Bruce.
Good on you, Drew. Have a great call today with John and also Curls. We'll take a break from the SCG, the second half after this.
Game. Cool pie.
It's the only one with sauce.
The AFL pie. The footy wars. What the 12th man did to cricket, the halfback flankers are doing to footy.
These cretins are taking the mickey out of everything
and everyone.
Misses by us, 15.
Oh, no. Me, Rixie.
We've got a lot of boring about Collingwood.
Tenacity, perspicacity and synchronicity.
Centimetre perfect.
What do you think? What do you think?
I tell you what I think.
Just another day in the commentary box, really.
You'd be an idiot not to get a copy.
There, can I go now?
Heart and soul, I fell in love with you. Heart and soul, just like a fool would do.
Did you know John Farnham is turning 50 this year?
50? 50 what?
Does that make me a grandmother?
He's not 50.
50?
He's older than that.
You're kidding.
I can't believe I'm 50.
You're invited to John Farnham's 50th. Join John and his friends, Human Nature, Kate Sobrano, James Rain, Merrill Bainbridge, Ross Wilson and Nana's Army. Extra shows now on sale. Let's party.
What's your secret?
Stir fry with satay sauce. Fountain sauce, of course.
Right now, your nearest mobile net dealer is holding three of a kind, including the Philips Savvy for just $49 on a mobile net value 10 or value 15 plan. Or how about the Panasonic G520, exclusive to mobile net at just $49. That's a $30 saving. And also at $49, you can grab the Motorola Jazz DB. At that price, you can afford to double up. Head to your nearest mobile net dealer for these great deals. They're one of a kind.
Dinner's in the oven. What's wrong?
My new accounts girl was killed at work today.
It's not your fault, is it, Dad?
There'll be an inquest. I think I'll be charged.
Sydney on this glorious winter's day. Sun shining brightly over the Sydney cricket ground, and it has been the most unusual half of footy with the Swans leading by 7 goals at quarter time, but having it eroded to 1 at the long break. Well, Terry Wallace is with Richard Osborne, the coach of the Bulldogs. We just might have a problem there for a moment, so we'll get back to that. They're coming back, they're both back on the ground. Now, Craig Bradley's playing his 300th game today. What a fantastic career he's had. And they're going through the banner, Bradley. So, terrific effort by him against Hawthorn today. We wish him well. What a wonderful player he's been. His kids, he was my mascot. Actually, I played in the Woodville under-19s. It shouldn't be so personal, but many years ago, his dad was our coach, Lionel Bradley, and Craig was our mascot. So, it's just, I feel like I've known him for so long. And he's one of the greatest all-round sports people that we've had in this country for a long time. To play Sheffield Shield cricket for both Victoria and South Australia. And what an athlete. And what a remarkable person I think he has been. A great example to everybody.
He'll keep playing, Bruce. He's got another year or two. If he can go to the half-back flank, he can play another 2 seasons.
How old were you in your last year, Doug?
35.
That's where he is at the moment, Bradley. And he'll be turning 36 in October. Now, Richard Osborne with Terry Wallace.
Well, Plough, I was going to ask you the question after the first quarter, what can you do? But you've got back into the game now. What did you say to the boys at quarter time?
Oh, look, we were really disappointed. We come up there to put on a good display. We haven't done that for a few years, and we were disappointed in our efforts. We had a few opportunities early in the first quarter to kick goals, missed them. They went up the other end and kicked theirs, and you just lose your way a little bit, lose a little bit of confidence. But, you know, we rallied, and I thought they did a pretty good job in the second quarter.
Thanks, Plough. Good luck in the second half.
Thank you for that, Richard, with Terry Wallace. Grant to Libba. Libba gets it to the goal square just about. Though it's tucked in the pocket. Big fly at the back came from Garlick and worked out to Maxfield. Maxfield's handball puts Stevens under the pump. Has to cough it up in the end. And Smith kicks a beauty right to the heart of the square. Dunkley's playing this real match here today and belts it over the line. Well, you'd reckon it would settle now, this match. Goal for goal a bit. We go back to that game in Perth, but it was 8-0 and then 8-8 at half time, and it did in the third quarter produced a terrific one, and in the end the West Coast got away from the Dogs towards the end of the match. But this has been just terrific. Nix, Saddington at the back, just had the reach on Dimatina, short to Carey in board, good, finds Bonford. Bonford was going to release O'Loughlin, decided not to. Kicks to Lewis, the beauty. Lewis didn't make it though. Really pro- probably should have. Brown's handball misses Curley. O'Loughlin, did he throw it? But he got it back to Kelly. Kelly, handball to O'Loughlin. He's on his left foot. Hooks it back hard. Plugger's got a chance here. Front spot. Lewis read it well. Don't tell me a second one. He's going to go through for a goal, I can tell you. He wanted to prove that Dougie the first one was no fluke. But it was Scotty Wine who was sitting on the bench the last time Dale Lewis did that.
Oh, he's a master at it, Dale Lewis. Here he is.
Haven't you changed your
tune? Oh, no, he's very good. He's very good. I just want to say, too, out of the 17 goals, 15 goals have been kicked down this one end, so this is the third quarter where the Sydney Swans are kicking.
I tell you what, that probably took you all of half time to work that out.
I had to make sure I got it right, Bruce. I had to head down working it out.
The Dogs out of the defence. Johnson a couple of touches. Now a third one, but he's given it from Liberatore back to Johnson. It's put him in all sorts of trouble, and the Swans are able to tie it up their side of the centre wing on the outer side. And it's that section of the crowd that has had all the action. Controversial 50-metre penalty against Paul Kelly in the second quarter to Tony Liberatore. Got the Dogs their first goal in that second quarter. And also a free kick to Nicky Winmar following it up. Two goals to the Dogs. That got them going. Working on the outer side. Dimatina has found Grant a little bit of space. Runs on to 50. Punches it low perfectly to Winmar. Two goals to Nicky Winmar in the second quarter. Lays it off when the angle's too tight. The Dogs just working quickly and sharply. Stevie Powell started the game on the bench. He's come on and has made a real difference in the game. Kicked a goal in the second quarter.
Good vision there, Wills, by Nicky Winmar. I mean, initially it was Chris Grant. The roles was, as I call him, a centre-half forward. His kick was absolutely spot on. And Winmar, instead of going back, he turned around and he found Stephen. As you said, Terry has been fantastic coming on and starting the game in the first quarter on the bench.
Powell being with the Dogs now. This is his third year. At senior level, he was runner-up in the reserves, best and fairest, back in 96. Since then, sprung a few games together. Since round four, he's played every game this year. An important kick to put the Dogs in front early in the second half. He's happy with it. They are there.
Right now, your nearest MobileNet dealer is holding three of a kind, including the Philips Savvy for just $49 on a MobileNet Value 10 or Value 15 plan. Or how about the Panasonic G520, exclusive to MobileNet at just $49. That's a $30 saving. And also at $49, you can grab the Motorola Jazz DB. At that price, you can afford to double up. Head to your nearest MobileNet dealer for these great deals. They're one of a kind.
Kicked eight of the last nine goals, the Doggies. Have a look at that scoreboard. We're back to square one, aren't we, after all of that? Well, the Swans, wouldn't they have frustrated their supporters today? And on the other hand, the Doggies supporters would be inspired. Crouch's handball, Goods didn't take it. And suddenly, the cleanness that the Swans had early has deserted them. And Creswell's handball to space, Curley gets back and does pretty well. Credit, the ball was smothered by Saddington. Chance for Adam Goods, and even the freakish nature of Goods is not coming off there as he kicks the ball out of bounds on the full. In the first quarter, he would have hooked that back on the left, plugged a little mark, and kicked a goal.
Yeah, good pick-up too by Adam Goods. The kick was no good, but, gee, this young fella's an exciting young player and has just so much ability.
Yes, he's a huge talent. You can imagine him being a great sportsman in anything, really a basketballer. You pick it down. Southern's in trouble. O'Loughlin's got him, had a second crack at it. Comes back towards Barry. Opportunity here, ridden to the ground. Stevens over the top. Was a Powell, gets a second go. Powell, little one. Oh, O'Loughlin snags it, not paid. Quick kick by Brown. Centre wing. Goods and Wine. Goods probably won it. Dimatina, terrific stuff to Smith. He's got liver wide. Can go all the way here, Smith. He runs too far.
Oh, way too far.
Well, no, he doesn't. The umpire says no. He kicks a goal. They're in front now. Well, that was a fantastic bit of play by Rowan Smith. But if he didn't run too far, I'll go he.
I think you caught it right, Bruce. Here, Adam Good threw all the hard work against Scotty Wine and used his body well. But Rowan Smith had Tony Liberatore. Here we go. He's still running. He's still running.
And 30 metres.
I reckon you're right, too. So, anyway, it's too late now. The score's on the board. It's another goal to Rowan Smith. Kicked two goals, but a very dangerous player in their forward line. And I think Matthew Nick's done a pretty good job on him as well. A bit lucky.
Back to the centre bounce. I got ahead of myself after the Stevie Powell goal. I had the Dogs in front. They are there now, thanks to Rowan Smith on the run, albeit a long run. Swans chance now. Greswell, no one coming to him. Bursts onto 50, left foot. It's straying wide. It's hit the behind post. Centre breaks always so important here at the SCG. And Aussie, the Bulldogs bench.
Hudson, Montgomery, Dent and Robbins. And wouldn't it be going through Rodney Ead's brain right now, what is going wrong?
Yeah, you just wonder if Hudson's injured. I mean, I don't think he's even had a kick at this stage of the game. Paul Hudson, one handball he's had, so he may be that hamstring. He's missed two games. That could be a bit of a problem for him again.
And actually, you and I spoke about it prior to the game, didn't we, Doug?
Yeah,
how
we will, yeah.
2 weeks out with a hamstring at 29 years of age, you don't always come back as quickly as you would thought. There's a couple of big flies there. And Carey, that's a contender under the pressure here. Every mark of the round, up he goes. And Darcy right there with him. At ground level, Goods couldn't find it. Liberatore back on out. Quick hands from Powell, West, Curley. The Dogs have run through the centre of the ground. Grant's got some space on Luff. Luff closes in quickly and does well to hold him up. So if Grant had stayed on his feet, he would have turned and been off. Still 70 metres out. Short chip. Finds Garley. Two goals in the second quarter to Simon Garley. Probes it into the forward line. Winmar from behind. Smith runs on a free kick against Winmar. Swans defence. Matthew Nixon.
Too.
Slow to get up. The umpire, very quickly himself, calls for the stretcher. There's the clash. Winmar coming over the top. You can see umpire Mark Nash indicate a free kick. Pushing.
Pretty tough boy, Nick. He's up on his feet. And looks like Nicky Winmar may have hurt his knee in that collision as well. Probably the blood rule, I think.
So Nick's
it is
up.
The blood rule, yeah.
Down they go. Smith looking dangerous on the burst there towards goal. It's all being held up.
Pretty good build-up too, Terry. In the first quarter when the Dogs were able to use the ball, they would have turned that footy over with that handball in their back line, but that's the difference now. The second quarter, they turned it all around, and it's been a good start for the Doggies in this third quarter for them.
Matthew Nix, who was a junior, broke both legs in separate instances. He didn't get to play football here with the Swans until 96. Since then, as Doug Hawkins indicated, he's found a real regular spot as the running halfback flanker for the Swans. Maxfield back on. John Stevens does the running for halfback out towards Carey. To a great mark before Darcy at ground level. Russell, quick hands back to Carey. Quick exchange. A little bit of space now for the Swans.
Bonford got a bad bounce. Carey was good there to McPherson. He's just come on the ground. Maxfield caught underneath it. Brown's got the mark.
And Hudson just coming on for the Western Bulldogs.
10-8 to 9-8. Brown's kick to centre wing. Here's Hudson. Well done, Dunkley. Kelly, terrific, to Crouch. Crouch attacks, wants Plugger. It's a tough kick, though, and at least, I guess, from the Swans' point of view, they've got it down there. They haven't done that too often since quarter time, 10-8 to 9-8.
Yeah, in the first quarter, Bruce, they would have found their targets, but at the moment, the Swans are missing their targets. Paul Hudson is a type of player who can kick you two or three quick goals very, very quickly. Dunkey's picking him up, too, at this stage.
Goods and Wine. And Creswell, Goods takes it out of the air and then misses a lot. Probably had more time in the end. I think he was free of the tackle. Didn't realise it. And what could have been a spectacular bit of play turned out to be a bit wasteful because it's the Doggies. I think everyone's a bit stunned here at the moment. Good mark at the back, Bonford. He's a bursty player. Saw a fair bit of him when he played at the Bombers. Not sure about his endurance levels, but he can get a kick in a hurry. The ball inside went through Creswell. Southern and also Crediuk. Ball still to be won. Crediuk hard. And that's the thing with the Doggies, of certainly their intensity level rose dramatically after quarter time. I think Terry Wallace would have been so disappointed with all of that in the first quarter. They were a bit too easy on the Swans, weren't they? Here's the marks. Advantage to the Swans, but the advantage on the scoreboard is certainly now with the Dogs. Johnson across the ground.
Towards this near side pocket. Garlic couldn't find the football. Pressure was good from O'Loughlin. The defence slaps towards the boundary line.
Just watching here, Wills. Nicky Wimmer now has been picked up by Dale Lewis. Dunphy, who's looked like playing on Paul Hutchin. Now the move's been changed there by Rodney. You'd see more now as playing on Hutchin, because Dunphy would have been a mismatch with Hutchin. Too quick over 10 metres.
So the Bulldogs, who have kicked 9 of the last 10 goals of the game, have got the run. The Swans need one here. Young Goods goes in towards the square, wobbles in there. Oh. Liberatore cleaning up ground level, not a good choice. A handball to the big man, floats over the top. Crop caught, Lockett stands, delivers across the body. He's missed as well.
Well, that's two handballs today. Tim Liberatore's missed his target. He missed Brad Johnson early in the first quarter by about 3 or 4 metres. And that one for Scotty Wong was just too hard, too long.
12 minutes into the third quarter. And there it is, Sydney's last goal by Michael O'Loughlin. Cameron on the burst to Garlick on the outer side. In low, and there's Smith, feeds it off again. Garlick keep coming.
It's been good Garlick since quarter time. Kicks wide to Winmar, a long way from home. Lewis with him. Winmar inside, putting his hand on it was Crouch. Couldn't take the mark. It was going to be a difficult one, but he held it up, which was a good result for the Swans. Smith goes to ground. Dunkley's having a magnificent match. Kelly, just a little one away, winds in the box seat. He's got it, and then it goes on. Back he goes, gets it to DiMartino, pops it up to Garlick. He's got it. He's a good kick too, Garlick. This is not beyond him. And Chris Grant, who's out of shot at the moment at centre-half forward, says go for it, but he decides to come into Johnson, and Johnson with a chance to kick a goal.
Good play. Good play by Scotty Wine. I mean, to set that play up there. The handball, sometimes the feedback does work, and that time it did over to Port DiMartino. Great vision.
13 goals in the first 6 weeks for Johnson, just 2 in the last 7. He's got it. It's a goal. It's a goal to the Dogs.
Win Big M's New Year, New Year competition, and you'll celebrate the new millennium in Sydney. Then cross the international dateline and do it all again in Hawaii. If you thought this New Year's Eve was going to be big, imagine doing it twice.
So 16 goals this year to Brad Johnson. It's an even spread of Bulldog scoring this year. He's one of 7 players who will kick more than 15. Wind, he's good in the centre, bounces for a big man. More often than not, he gets it out. This time it out towards DiMartino. Props comes back inboard. Kicks towards centre half forward. The kick's a good one in there towards Powell. Floats over the top. Grant doing the roving. Back on out to Johnson. Here to Winmar. Winmar runs in. Handball's over the top. Hudson on the ground. Goes whack and gets his first. The Dogs are unstoppable.
Gee whiz. What a turnaround. 8 goal kickers now for the Western Bulldogs. And against all odds, I mean, down the uprooms where all the goals have been kicked, the Western Bulldogs so far in his third term have kicked 4 goals down the wrong end of the game, or wrong end of the ground, and just quick hands by Brad Johnson. Nicky Wimmer, matter of fact, had his back to the play, turned around, the ball was in his hands, and that's Paul Hutchins' first kick. That's the goal, but, gee, the Dogs are on fire.
Unbelievable. It's a ridiculous, probably a very naive question. Can you start a match too well? I mean, you just wonder, the Swans, it came too easy to them, you wonder. And suddenly now where it's hard and tough, they're nowhere near it.
And you spoke earlier, Bruce, of just those two undisciplined pieces of play that started the second quarter, and the goals to Liberatore and Winmar. That's where the catalyst for the Dogs' return came.
And it's still happening here. Johnson can go over the top, takes his man on, gets it to Darcy, can go back, decides not to, loads up. This is close. It's Winmore. Nicky, it was either a mark or a goal, but in the end for him, it was the wrong result. It was going through. Easy from here to say that. Nicky committed to the ball. But, gee, it was close to over the line anyway.
Yeah, just lets that one go, Bruce. It certainly would have been a goal. But Brad Johnson has been absolutely fantastic. Had a great first half at Western Bulldogs. Had plenty of football. Probably had 20-odd possessions and been a very dangerous player.
Chris Grant, sorry, Doug, with a blood rule. Chris Grant, so that's an important one. Nick's still off the ground, isn't he?
Yeah, he's coming back on now, Bruce.
So Grant off and Nick's on. Well, it's a 3-goal game. I mean, it was a 7-goal game the other way at quarter time. But dare to suggest that the Dogs can get another one or two in this spurt, then Sydney are nearly out of this match. They're just stuck, aren't they? It's like a quagmire for them at the moment. Lewis down the ground. Carey's got it. Now they've got to move it on.
Just didn't want the big man to go to ground then, did they? They had runners, but when he went, they lost that momentum.
Nix has got it. Oh, he's kicked it straight to Scotty Wine.
The big men working together. Swan and the Bulldog, they give it off to Liberatore. Now here's Smith. Works again out here with Hudson. He's kicked the last one. Runs in. Welsh run down there by Nix. Off on the blood rule. Now back on the ground and charges it down on Hudson. Turns it back the Swan's way. Seymour on the outer side. Kicks in towards the flank. Schwass and Liberatore. Schwass turns it back. Saddington can't get it away. And it's a boundary throw-in.
I think two rules there. Matthew Nix knew quite well he made the bad mistake. He turned the ball over, kicked it to Scotty Wine, said, I've got to make up for that. And he certainly did that. Very unusual to see Nix come forward and not find a target.
It's a long scoreline there for Sydney. One goal since quarter time. Dogs have rattled them on. They've kicked 11. Sydney, their chance here, forward pocket, and not even that favours. And Stephen Crediel, happy to take the ball over the line. Boundary throw in, forward pocket for Sydney.
Looks like Dunkley may be coming off the ground. I think he's probably been one of their best players. Off the ground he goes. O'Connor on.
Boundary throw in. Wine with a backhand. Can't get it away and it'll be held up again. Creswell and Schwass doing the tackling in there on Scotty West. He was going nowhere in that sort of traffic.
Rowan Smith now has gone the full four. The Western Bulldogs being picked up by Bond. It's been a pretty good play for the Swans.
Swans desperate to get something happy. They need a goal and then maybe they can get some inspiration from it. 20 metres from their goal, belted away by Darcy, went through the fingers of McPherson. O'Loughlin, who started so brilliantly, as did the whole of the team. Brown, Liver, worried out of it. McPherson paddling it forward behind. Two grabs for the Swans at the moment when they go forward. Doggies, 12-9 to 9-10. Amazing scoreline. We've got the sequence on the big scoreboard at the moment of when both teams kick the goals, but lots of S's early and a whole lot of W's ever since. Taken by Goods, but it's a boundary throw-in. Well, they'd be absolutely kicking themselves, the Swans, to have put themselves in this position after having a stranglehold on this match at quarter time. Full credit to the Dogs.
But in terms of the venue, Bruce, it's not going to take much for them to get back in. It just doesn't look it at the moment. They look quite dispirited, but a goal their way will turn it back, I'm sure.
Hudson's got it, yeah.
He's made a difference just in these last few minutes, hasn't he?
Well, Dougie suggested he's a man to kick a couple in a hurry. Smith was very good to Winmar, who's normally an excellent finisher. Coming back, just missing. Behind. It's been pretty good, Winmar. Hasn't touched it a lot, but something has happened when he has. Smith becoming very important, and it's still a three-goal game.
Yeah, I just reckon the Sydney Swans have fallen down at centre-half forward. Their marking down there really hasn't been much there for them today. It looks like Adam Goods has gone to centre-half forward, been picked up by Daniel Southern.
So Matthew Nix, a little kick to himself, then runs another 15 metres. Big Ryan O'Connor over the top of Darcy and Carey. Off to Creswell, Creswell to half forward. On the burst, O'Loughlin needs to keep it going. Lockett's back in the square. The kick's not going to quite reach him. They're going to ask Luff to do it. He can't get the jump. Montgomery spoils. Swash Rhodes. Oh. A poor handball back. It was a blind one. It was going nowhere. He should have come round on his left. That's what he's made to do. The Dogs repel it. Johnson, he's made to run. Kicks it beautifully. Dimatina missed both final series the last couple of years. He's out to do well. The kick to centre half forward. Seymour drops what he should have taken. Nix cleans up at ground level. Kelly at circle work. Oh, they're going down the other side now. Oh. It's the Swans' chance. McPherson desperately needing a goal. Centre half forward. Lockett's going to make it. Can't quite take it. Croft was right with him. O'Connor back to Schwass. Use your left foot, son. Use it. Kick it. He's missed it.
Oh, Wayne.
That was a harder one than the one before, wasn't
it? It was, Bruce. I mean, he should have kicked it. Instead of the handball, it certainly wasn't on. The handball's the wrong option. I mean, a player of his quality should have known a lot better than kick the ball instead of handball. But, gee whiz, when are they going to get the next goal?
It's a good question, Doug. 9-11 to 12-10. One goal since quarter time. That was halfway through the second quarter. Crediuk, Carey, quick kick away by Garlick. Winmar and Lewis. Lewis belts it. Bomford, it was a hard one to control. Well done, Tim Martina. Terrific stuff to Winmar. Pops it up. Smith's normally good in this situation. Nicks may be the answer here. Holds on. Nicks over the top. Tries to get control of it. Smith and Hudson. Saddington kept his cool. That was good play to Luff. Luff looks up. Kicks it very well to Bomford. Bomford strides away. Takes Tim Martina on. Then goes in short and finds O'Loughlin. A better build-up. Pluggers in the goal square. Wants it long. O'Loughlin's kick is a beauty. Where are they going to get their goal from? Mickey O'Loughlin. That's where, Dougie.
There's one golden rule.
It's going to kill your mum.
When you teach.
You don't get too close to it.
Always stay calm and relaxed.
Temper's got a bit frayed.
We just end up screaming at each other.
It's the final testing time for our learners tonight on 7. A chance discovery.
Bones were scattered in all directions.
Human bones found in a remote corner of the wilderness.
We have approximately 5%.
But whose remains are they?
Haven't got anyone that fits the criteria.
Australia's Most Wanted, Monday.
The Sydney chant goes up. They've kicked only two goals since quarter time. You wouldn't believe it. 22 minutes into the third quarter. Dogs leading by the 11. It's had everything.
Free Worked kick, there. I think it will. It's a free kick to the Swans.
You wouldn't want the discipline to be lost that the Bulldogs have shown right throughout this big comeback. It's Creswell. What a competitor. Duel with Scotty West has been one to watch today. Into the pocket. Spoil was good from Brown. Too slow to get rid of it was Johnson. Likewise with Cameron. The Swans attack ferociously. West spinning this way, that way. There's a touch of class. Not to another good youngster in Brown. Wobbles it in. Johnson another touch. Racking them up. That's 26 for the afternoon. Scotty West left foot. Forward line. Bounces there in front of Hudson. His hamstrings all right, Hawk.
Yep.
Just wasn't getting enough of the football early. Smith. Rowan Smith, 5 goals last week, right towards the square. Grant flies. It's a behind.
Yeah, a couple of important touches for Scotty West. I mean, 3 best and fairest. He's been an absolutely fantastic player. Chris Grant going for the second grab, but no doubt the ball was over line. But Scott West's handball over the shoulder is absolutely spot on. First class.
Fosdyke short to Luff. 10-11 to 12-11. Luff to Saddington. Saddington away from Winmar. Left foot, Goods versus Southern. It was too far for Goods. Well played, Danny Southern. The one-on-one, when it came in, you'd reckon Goods would be a hard man to beat. Cameron, what a wonderful kick he is. Both sides, as we've said. Winmar picked up the scraps and then handball to Johnson. Johnson, cozy little kick to Grant. Nice one. Grant's reach is too good. Very few players will beat Grant one-on-one. And he's got it in the pocket. Now, what would really hurt the Swans here is if he could kick a goal. He's asking.
What's he saying here?
Stephen Powell's just come off the ground, been right at their best, obviously just for rest.
I think he wants to know the line so he can mark his spot. Whether this, we saw him do this earlier today.
Now, the thing with this technique, Bruce, is that Chris will then just watch that spot. He's lined up a straight line from that spot to the centre of the goals, and that will just keep his head down. Now, he's just gone and fooled me completely. But I knew what the technique he was about. He's just fooled a lot of them.
Troy Luff was probably standing about 5 metres away from the mark. I think Chris Grant may have been Will's mark on the response kick from your right there, but Leon Cameron, will he kick right or left foot? Who knows?
He normally goes right on that.
Yeah, right on the left
shot. You'd like to see Mark out under that left.
Yep.
He seems to hit it further on the left than his right.
Stevens coming off for the Swans. Barry coming back. So Cameron to put a 3-goal gap in the game. Outside 50. Good kick. Probably not going to be a goal. Oh, terrific mark by Darcy. He stood tall there. And we did see Keating and Lepich take a lot of those on the line against the Swans last week. Dudley's off the ground, isn't he? I reckon he would have been too handy back there with what he's done so far today in that situation.
He certainly would have been, Bruce. He would have probably made a great contest there. But Luke Darcy had been a fairly quiet day for him. It looks like Leon Cameron just came off the ground. He's been a very good player down there. He cut Dale Lewis out of the game. I thought Cameron was terrific, and Robinson's back on.
Of course, Dudley off with Cook off the ground, so the mismatch. But Darcy puts them 3 in front.
the perfect footballer.
His butt
is a hard man to catch.
That little bit there.
As elusive as back-to-back premierships.
I think it's quite unattractive.
Wednesday, live and kicking bears all.
Who's that?
As you get to choose.
I like a six-pack.
The hunkiest guy in the AFL today.
Well, that's not bad, is it?
Live and kicking.
He's got a very cute bum.
Oh, the chest is nice.
Wednesday on Channel 7.
Darcy gets his first of the Western Bulldogs. Step on out now to 3 clear goal lead. Biggest lead they've had, but quite unbelievably, Sydney led by 40 points at quarter time. And it was how far the red and white, but the Dogs have worked their way back into it. It's been tough and hard. Liberatore on the outer side tosses it out, doesn't quite reach West. Swasser's there, joined now by Grant, Creswell. The Dogs trying to work it out. Matty Robbins can see just a little bit of ground to liver. Some trouble now, but steps around as the little man.
Oh,
under pressure from the crowd as well. The kick not quite so good. Stephen Carey back. Windmark closing. Carey's kick's a good one. Schwartz to the run there of McPherson. Pressure from the tackle was good. The kick goes to centre half forward. Goods being a little bit cute with the hands. Pretty, he's not. He'll just charge the ball away. Flicks it on out the back. Curly across the body. Johnson just a neat little flick over the back. That tackle's high, surely. No, says the umpire. No one's going anywhere. Handball on out to Dent. Now the umpire surely has to make a decision. And I agree with you, sir. That definitely was around the net.
I just think, Will, the umpire was caught in the wrong spot. He was caught behind that one. Initial low tackle there, I think it was from Dimitina, was around the neck. The kick was certainly there.
Tough day for Stuart Wynn. Gave the 50-metre penalty to Tony Liberatore and gave the free kick to Nicky Winmar. So those two goals got the Dogs going.
Darcy to Barry. Barry's handball to space. It's a good option, I think. Bomford clever to Lewis. They're just doing it by bits and pieces. Bomford got it off Creswell. Kicks to O'Loughlin. Caught underneath it. Got a little shove. Curley's been pretty good. Back it goes. Brown, clever kick. Finds Winmar at halfback. Dimitina loves to run with the footy. Kick towards centre wing. Smith attacks it hard and then turns. Nix a bit inside out though. Nix doesn't get much ground and did well, I thought. Nix just kept enough pressure on Smith. A lesser player would have been turned inside out and Smith would have been away. So it's Fosdyke getting it from Luff. Swans need one in the last couple of minutes to give them some momentum before three-quarter time. One the other way would nearly put them out of reach. Southern, O'Connor charged him. Dimitina back to Winmar, playing deep for the moment. The handball's well weighted. Darcy very good to Swine, to Southern, practically hands it in the end. To Brown, Brown, oh, he'll have a look at this. Missile on his own, I can't believe it. I looked up, he'll kick a goal. Rowan Smith runs in. Well, he doesn't. Oh. He does not. He tried to be too cute, I think, in the end.
He certainly did, Bruce. I mean, he had Paul Hudson. Okay, the kick could have been on, but Rowan Smith should have kicked that goal. And Matthew Nix was 30 metres away there, Wills.
Bruce, in our days gone by, Georgie Bissett was out with us. And Georgie would always say, in wet conditions, yeah, just bounce it in the square and it'll skid through. But in these firmer ones, Rowan Smith had to put it back in the grandstand. He had to kick through the ball. Missed a great opportunity there. So the Swans with a chance. It's Saddington in the back pocket. Just goes long towards the wing. Dogs at ground level. There's 3-1. Kelly works hard against them. Nix is there with them now. Fosdyke to Luff under pressure. Stands, kicks towards centre forward. Wine goes back. Seymour comes through hard. Turns it back again. Bumford has been so very good. His kick's not. His kick is not a good one.
Just think, you know, Tony Lockie's kicked the 3 goals. He's a very dangerous player one-on-one, but the Swans don't give him any opportunity.
He's having to work hard today. He's kicked 3 in the first half, 2 in the first and 1 in the second. Kelly desperately needs something out of this. This is the spot that Kelly slotted Tony Lockie for goal number 1300. I don't think Lockett's coming this time. It's all with Paul Kelly, the captain. It wobbles, it floats, it's dropped short.
It couldn't have, could it?
It has.
goal. The Swans sneak back in.
Well, a little bit of a nowhere kick that one by the skipper Paul Kelly, but there it is, the captain's goal. He's done it so many times throughout his career. He's just an absolutely fantastic player, Paul Kelly. Western Bulldogs should have probably had a bigger player back there in that goal, so he probably could have touched the ball. Went over the top of Matthew Dent. There's Matthew Croft diving across. That's a captain goal to Paul Kelly. Probably not a big game to his standards, but still, when someone needs to lift the game, his one player can certainly do that.
He might have a big last quarter.
Oh, yeah.
What they need. Well, that does tighten it up, doesn't it? It gives the Swans a real snip here. Very late in this third quarter. 11-11 to 13-12. Darcy easily over the top. McPherson, who came on halfway through this quarter. High ball. I think we'll run out of time before three-quarter time. Prettyhook's got it. Plays on quickly. Dimatina on the end of it. Had a terrific turn to Johnson. And I think the Swans are relieved because the Doggies had something set up. Well, the Swans need a huge lift here. The Bulldogs have been fantastic. If they can win today, this will be a huge victory in the context of their season, remembering they were 7 goals behind at quarter time. Knicks took a very hard bump in that quarter. Kelly kicked rather a fortunate goal towards the end, but it could really make for the Swans in the last quarter. They've got to get something from somewhere. Haddo got one in that quarter, missed another. And at three-quarter time, it's the Doggies over the Swans, 13-12 to 11-11.
Which one-ton club cab offers more cab storage space than any other ute in its class? Which one-ton ute now offers soundproofing at passenger car levels? And which one-ton ute features side intrusion beams for that unexpected impact? One-ton Triton.
Game. Cool pie.
It's the only one with sauce.
The AFL pie.
The Bank of Melbourne serves you better. On Saturday mornings, when the other banks are sleeping in, the Bank of Melbourne is open to serve you better. The Bank of Melbourne cuts the cost of banking.
Australian workers live in a free country. Now they can work in one as well. If you choose to belong to a union, you can. If you choose not to belong, you can do that too. The decision is entirely up to you. If you're being intimidated or discriminated against, call this number. Or maybe you're just like a booklet. Freedom of association. It's your call.
Authorised by C. Ellison, Commonwealth Government, Canberra.
Orders closed 16th of July 1999.
Where are my socks? If I don't get those socks, I'm out of business.
Did you check all your stocks?
There's no socks in my stocks.
Check down by the docks.
I'm the docks. It's no socks.
I've checked every box. There's no box full of socks.
Forget about socks. I just saw a fox.
We got locks.
We got frocks.
Not frocks, not walks, not locks, just socks.
Yeah, I've got your clocks.
Supply chain problems? IBM has internet solutions.
Sure, blame the Scots.
How does it happen? You're racing a fuse or printing the news, and you strain till you think that you'll burst. You sure got a thirst. A hard-earned thirst needs a big cold beer, and the best cold beer is Victoria Bitter. It can come at any time. You're taking a vow or chasing a cow.
Matter of fact, I got it now.
Victoria Bitter.
McDonald's McMagic Monopoly. Now make some of the big winners. Rachel Clark from Queensland.
and the Morgan family from New South Wales, and Pat Collins from Tasmania.
McMatch and Win Monopoly, stick around. This is big.
Three-quarter time here at the SCG as we welcome you back, and the Bulldogs with a fantastic comeback here, and they lead 13-12 to 11-11. Two other matches being played in Melbourne, another one to come in Adelaide. Quarter-time scores here, the Bombers over the Dockers. It's 6-1 to 2-2 at quarter-time there, and Carlton playing Hawthorn. The Hawks lead 1-6 to the Blues 1-1.
Seven Sport hope you're enjoying this match as part of the 1999 Coca-Cola AFL Premiership season.
And welcome back to the SCG here. Well, at quarter time we're wondering if the Swans could lose, and at three-quarter time we're wondering, in fact, if they can get up. The Kelly goal's important, Ozzy. It must have given them a bit of a lift at three-quarter time.
It did, and what an very ordinary kick too, Bruce, almost like only being worth 5 points. It just wobbled through, perhaps a bit of a mistake by the Western Bulldogs, but, they've got the run of the play at the moment, the Dogs. Terry Wallace has really used his bench well, in particular Steve Powell. It's rumoured that he can't run a game out at the moment, so they've been having him on and off the bench. I'd say they'd start him again. He'll run home very strong. So the trend has been that most of the goals have been kicked to the Paddington end, left of screens. The Dogs are looking pretty good at this stage.
Yeah, they're going to be hard to beat. Stephen Kerry took a beautiful mark in the third quarter, a contender for the Cadbury Mark of the Year. There's a lot of flyers here. He was third man in line, Darcy coming over the top. That's a terrific grab. He played pretty well in that quarter, Stephen Kerry. They do need something from somebody. Maybe Kelly will be the one, Paul Kelly. He's done it for a decade here. Perhaps he can do it again in the last quarter.
Yeah, certainly, Bruce. I'm just thinking they fell down a bit at centre-half forward to Sydney Swans. Ryan O'Connor now has gone to centre-half forward, being picked up by Daniel Southern. Tony Lockett, of course, in the goal square. Michael Lockett starting right next to Tony Lockett. He could be the man too down there forward line to kick a couple of goals for the Swans.
Well, what a big last quarter this will be. The stakes were high prior to the match. They're even higher now because of the way this match has been played out. One team seemingly home and now the other one in a winning position. The Swans, well, this would be a very bitter loss for them, and it would be about as sweet as you get if the Bulldogs can go on and win it. Terry Wallace has not coached the Bulldogs to a victory here. The kick by Goods, inside 50. Bouncing ball, O'Connor can't quite get a hold of it. Fosdyke, little left footer, could be important. Croft in front of Plugger. Plugger couldn't run him down, then brought him down as he kicks the ball to centre wing. Mark taken by Barry. Every contest will be important early in this last quarter. Short to Schwoss. A couple of his options today haven't been the right ones. But he is a great player and could turn it on in the last quarter. Floats it to full forward. O'Loughlin, front spot. Brought to the ground by Southern. Wine wants the boundary line. Working towards it, and it finds it. A boundary throw in left forward pocket. Who's on the bench for the Swans, Ozzy?
Dale Lewis, Andrew Dunkley, Stuart Maxfield, and Scott Russell.
Jeez, some experience there.
You think Dunkley must be Cook. He had a terrific first half of the Sydney side, and he can't work that one out.
I think it's just the fact that Cook's not on the ground, to be honest, Hook. O'Connor. Hi, Darcy's got it.
Yeah, with Dunkley, when he came off, he did sit next to the doctor, but they didn't talk at all, so I don't think he's injured.
Darcy kicks it as hard as he can. Southern the target. McPherson did a good job. Now Goods. Will he go back inside? Southern held it up. Back to Goods. And a few of the things that Adam Goods has tried in the second half haven't worked. Robbins caught high. Well, he was initially by Crouch, and he's got the free kick in front of us.
There it is, the hand over the shoulder, Crouch. So Robbins, his league debut with Geelong. Now with the Bulldogs, Nathan Brown. He's been very good in defence. Good use of the ball. So the left footer keeps along the boundary line. Up towards Brown. Well, all the high flying is with the Swans, and Troy Lupp judges it very well over Grant.
There is again here, Terry. Now, great mark by Troy Lupp. It's been a pretty even contest, these two.
Besides, this time to come along the boundary line after some adventurous play earlier in the game when he went inside and just conservatively comes along the boundary line. And Aussie, the Bulldogs on the bench.
Montgomery, Cook, Cameron and Powell. And Troy Lupp's mark, that happened right in front of me. Certain contender for Cameron Mark of the Year.
Throwing in. Leon Cameron looks on. Luke Darcy takes the ball. National pack nearly passes it to Cameron. Out of bounds on the full. So Sydney with opportunities in their forward half. Creswell, who has now gone on to Johnson in this final quarter. Brad Johnson being so dominant. 31 touches in the game. Half forward, there's the mark. The skipper's in there. Paul Kelly, a long way out. He kicked from 55, so you'd expect there'd need to be another disposal before the Swans had a shot on goal. Here it is, chips it in short, got it. Leo Barry just floats in perfectly. Bad checking by the Dogs' defence. This man ain't a bad kick at goal either.
I'll just tell you what happened there, Wills. When Paul Kelly had the ball, had control of the football, Matthew Depp was trying to be that player to stand in the hole in front of Tony Locke, and that's his opponent, Leo Barron. He just gave him just too much room, trying to do the right thing by his side.
13 points, the difference. Leo Barry, 9 goals, 6 from the season. Deliberately, the left footer kicks. Oh. He's hit the post. Inch by inch, the Swans keep coming back.
Just looking at Wayne Swass now. He's trying to drag Tony Liberatore inside 50. That could be a bit of a problem for Western Bulldogs if Swass goes forward with Liver.
Off the side a bit from Croft. Barry's high fly. Which way will it bounce? Barry might have been a bit unlucky. He's going to get a free kick. Wasn't a lot in him, but Southern tackled him. So maybe the Swans, or Credilk, I should say.
Credilk, yeah.
Maybe the Swans can have a break or two. That's a very ordinary kick. Stevens has belted away. Couldn't control it there. McPherson, it was an important one. Robbins comes away. That's a bad kick. So some mistakes creeping in here. Knicks. Not one team has been able to make a move in this last quarter. The Swans have had the ball in attack practically throughout, though. Luff's got it. Can stroll away now. And bang hard and long, but he's kicked it straight to Doggy's left, right, center. They spoil one another. O'Loughlin, Kelly. Kelly's kick for goal. Misses. We're all waiting for somebody to do something.
Just some of the Sydney kicking has been disappointing. Just not spinning the ball well at all. And that one in there wasn't a marked one. Now, Andrew Dunkley, we know, is on the bench. Here he is in the third quarter. Just a slap there through there with Smith. Ooh, and just his little twinge down he goes there. So that's the reason he's sitting right next to the doctor on the interchange bench. He's watching his side have a comeback here at the Bulldogs. Bruce Pagavani indicated all the play has been in the Swans forward line. Bulldogs now with their first chance through Southern in the half forward. Kicks a good one, Smith. Good mark also. Away he goes. Wheels around on the right foot. The kick's a good one. Floats over the top. Well judged. Rowan Smith's kicks generally cover another 5 or 6 metres than what you would generally expect.
Yeah, there's a spot on kick, Wilson, and Daniel Southern, good run from him too. He's playing at centre half back. He's picking up Adam Goods now, who's gone forward. It was good play by Southern to come forward and give his teammates an option to kick the ball to. Good play by him.
Chris Grant, 1 goal, 2 behinds. Sees Mark the spot on the ground. And as I was trying to explain earlier, what that does is has him concentrate on that spot. And then that keeps his head down over the ball.
Big kick, Wills, this one.
Chris Grant. Dual best and fairest winner for the Dogs. He's got it.
Property buyers. Whether you're buying a home or an investment, the Bank of Melbourne can approve your loan on the spot. In your branch, in your home, in your office, 7 days a week. The Bank of Melbourne cuts the cost of banking.
McDonald's McMatchin win Monopoly.
Now meet some of the big winners. Rachel Clark from Queensland. And the Morgan family from New South Wales. And Pat Collins from Tasmania.
McMatchin win Monopoly.
Stick around. This is big.
Well, this match far from over, but that's going to make it hard for the Swans because they had the ball forward for so long. And as it so often happens, the opposition run it down through some very good footy and Grant finished it off. Wine, O'Connor, Credilk to Garlick. Kelly took it off him, hits it hard and high. Blake is going to have to take one here. Never got into it, didn't get a free kick. Fosdyke there with the Brown. Brown's made a terrific game. Comes to the line. Robbins is there with Curley. Robbins has got it. Doggy's playing confidently. Robbins' kick is in the Garlick direction. Kelly at the back. He's playing the last quarter. Kelly in short. McPherson, certainly the sun out on the fall against Robbins, unlucky.
And he just lost sight of the ball, because you called that right. I mean, McPherson just couldn't see where the ball was. But that skipper, Paul Kelly, what a great mark, what a great player he is.
So McPherson, normally a good field kick here. Schwoss works for him. He comes across the ground. Interesting kick to Saddington. He's going to pay it. He's going to pay it. And he had a fair bit of it, the kid. He controlled it. It was a lovely kick.
Yeah, it was a great kick. He had Schwoss short, but the kick to Saddington has come down from the half-back flank. His opponent is Paul Hudson. No doubt the decision by the umpire was absolutely spot on.
Well, he averages one goal every 3 weeks, this fellow. They do need one here. He's a good player, a really good talent. In his second season, a lot of pressure on him here. If they keep missing these, they won't win. He's got it. They're still in it.
You can get it dipping. You can get it chipping. You can get it having a row. A hard-earned thirst needs a big cold beer. And the best cold beer is Vic, Victoria Bitter. You can get it lumping. You can get it thumping. You can get it any old how. Matter of fact, I got it now. Victoria Bitter.
And the SCG crowd starting to find voice. Sydney need the next goal. They haven't kicked consecutive goals since the first quarter. They must do that to break the back here of the Bulldogs. Bulldogs have had the answers each time since quarter time. It's at half forward. Western Bulldogs, Liberatore in underneath. Stolen away by Creswell. Weaves a handball. Doesn't really clear the area. They still have to work it hard. Quick kick by the Dogs. Back in the four-line. Grant again. He's got it. He's off. That's what he wants to do. Along the ground. He's missed.
Calling the Rolls-Royce, he's turned into a Volkswagen after that one. I'll tell you what, it was a terrific mark by Chris Grant. He just pushed his opponent, Love, under the ball. Troy Love played on, probably did the right thing, but instead of just jabbing the ball, you said, Wills, in the wet conditions, yeah, fine, do that, but just kick the ball a lot harder, a bit higher, Chris Grant.
Nothing wrong with the plan, it was just the execution.
Yeah, just didn't kick it well.
13 points. Nicks, as you would expect, straight up the ground. 11 minutes gone in the final quarter at the SCG. Krediuk, wanting to celebrate his birthday in style, goes wide, finds Hudson. Just inside 50 is Paul Hudson.
If anyone can kick these, Will, this bloke can.
He's the leading goal scorer with the Dogs this year. Kicked 61 last year. And has the prodigy of a goal scorer. That's not a bad looking kick. Goal umpire has a good look at it, but it's away to the far side, one behind. Dogs now missing their chances to really nail the game home.
Yeah. Just think if the Dogs get one, Bruce, it could be a little bit hard for the Sydney Swans to get right back in this now.
Well, we're back to the margin at three-quarter time now. And they've got to take chances, the Swans. Nicks gets it from Kelly. Oh. It's a terrible kick. Darcy should swallow it. He does in the end. Gargled it a bit, didn't he?
Yeah.
Then kicks it into Ryan Smith. He's a danger man at 50. He is a real danger man, this fellow. Robin's coming off. Smith kicked four goals against Fremantle in round 12 and five against the Bombers in round 13. And so far today has kicked two. This, not beyond him. He decides to kick it beautifully. Mark not taken by Hudson. Handball by Lever. Garlick. Still the handball. Southern. High ball. To be won. Kelly was magnificent coming in on Krediuk. Krediuk was terrific. Grant's got it. Well done, Krediuk.
Oh, that number 35 jumper. Steve, well done.
He's made you proud. Oh, well, that the old 35.
I mean, Kelly and Krediuk, then that was just sensational. When no one really could find the handle on the football anywhere there, and it was tossed up. Had to be one, and both men so hard at it.
Yeah, Paul Hudson probably should have swallowed that kick. It was a brilliant kick by Rowan Smith. You just got to take those catches. When I say catches, those marks, you've got to grab them.
Powell on for Hudson. Well, this is the goal that you talked about, Hawk. The next goal that would really hurt them. Just a little bit nervous of your doggy supporter, Chris Grant. Straight in front. No, he's got his third.
Come on, ball, guys.
Hands behind the opportunist McLeod. Open goal and he's got it.
Silvani takes the
A game. Cool pie.
The Great Southern Pie. The only official pie of the AFL.
Well, this certainly is a battle between two of the leading clubs in the competition. Since 1995, the two clubs have taken in turns to win. Today was to be Sydney's turn, to fight desperately hard in the final stages of the game. 20 minute mark, final quarter. The Dogs in defence. Southern stands strong. He wants a mark and a free kick. Can only give you one of those, Daniel. Cameron Powell. We've found some room. Credio floating on down.
Just their back line, Terry's given a lot of run at the moment, the Western Bulldogs. Critic's gone forward from a half-back. I think we've seen Daniel Southern now do it twice. So they're starting to really work and run hard. And Cameron, when he gets the ball, just uses the ball so well, Leon.
And Andrew Dunkley's come off of the Swans, so that baffles us even more.
Freddie, 9 goals in a career. He realises that, wants to give it to Cameron, but the umpire's not happy with that. Why, I'm not sure. He's not lining him up to make sure he's straight on goal. Goodness sake.
Can't do that.
Well, here he goes. Credio. A disciplined kick to the top of the square. They set themselves. Two Swans players couldn't complete it. Powell trying to get down over the top. Seymour's there. Powell does it from behind. Can't get the kick. The second go. The Dogs have gold one, I reckon. No. Simon Garlick, he's got two on the board. Couldn't squeeze that third one out.
I'll just tell you, next week, correct me if I'm wrong here, North Melbourne, the Kangaroos take on the Western Bulldogs. A great encounter that's going to be, MCG.
On Sunday.
Sunday.
Well, this game's not over, Doug.
Nah.
There's still a game to be won here, but they need a goal. Dunkley with Darcy. They need a goal, the Swans. They need one in the next minute or so. Big fly, terrific mark, Stephen Carey. Well, he's had a couple of Cadburys today. That's a beauty. They must goal here. Shocking kick. Lucky for Creswell. He's got Luff on. Doesn't use him. Now uses him. He's a good kick, Luffy. He'll need his best. He wanted to go on. He didn't go over the mark. Creswell just took a little while to go to Luff, and in the end,
he just didn't seem to have that confidence to give it to him, did he?
He is a good kick, Luffy. A good field kick. This would test him. They just have to kick these, though. They've got to find a couple that are a bit against the odds for them to win. He's 50 out. He's kicked it pretty well. Lockett flies. It's a behind. Not good enough. 12-14 to 15-15. They must get full return from all of their attacks from here on in. Nothing we've seen really for an hour has suggested they can win, to be honest.
And it's really dried up for Tony Lockett, hasn't he?
Yep.
He's kicked 3 goals in the first half. And here's Matthew Croft. This is only his 3rd kick for the day in game number 100, but it's one to remember. You can hold Tony Lockett to just 3 goals at the SCG. A wonderful effort. And that goes a long way to producing a win for your side. Smith, he's been busy. This will be disposal number 21. He's kicked 2 goals as well. Grant starting to get into play in the half forward line. Skips on over the back. Leo Barry needs to come straight now. Won't come back on his right. He wants to stay on his left. He's run a long way across goal towards the outer side. Seymour, there were 3 Swans there. They're away now. It's got to reach Kelly. The bounce. Dent comes back first. The Swans have lost a chance here because Dent works with Brown. Brown can't find the handle on the football. Kelly comes again. They need to get it on out. Nix swoops it on out. Eventually O'Loughlin to Russell on the run. Chips it up over the top. Is it going to be straight? Another poster. They can't buy a goal, the Swans.
You just think they kicked that one. They're back in the hunt here. But gee whiz, they've just worked so hard to get the ball forward. It's just disappointing for the Sydney Swans. Hit the post twice.
Cameron was good. He charged down Russell and made him kick high. Short kick in. It's okay. It's found Dimitina.
It's good mark by Dimitina. He had to find something there, and he did. It's a 3-goal margin still. Dimitina to Credio. Goods comes in. Credio's having a very good match.
Yeah, that's worth playing. He had a great game.
Remember when he started? What a great
prospect he looked. He's had a good career. He's been unlucky with injuries, hasn't he? But perhaps he's still got four or five terrific years in front of him. Cameron's kick to Grant. Nearly a terrific mark by Chris Grant. Dunkley now on him and a boundary throw-in. Well, the Swans have played seven games at home prior to today this season for four wins and three losses. If they lose today, and that's the likely result now, they're going to be 50-50 here. Not the result they want, and not good enough to get them really into a top part of the final eight, if into the final eight at all. They're going to give everyone heart here if they lose. Nix gets it back from Goods, takes his time to kick. O'Loughlin wind it very well in the sun. Comes back to Luck. Well done, McPherson. McPherson to Plaga. Couldn't quite. Well played, Croft. Southern to Curley. Out of play. When Plaga kicked his third goal, the score was 9-4. A lot has happened since then.
Yeah, it certainly has, Bruce. I just don't think the Swans have really used Tony Lockett a hell of a lot. And I just think since he broke that record a few weeks back, he hasn't really had a big impact in the last 3 or 4 weeks for Sydney Swans.
Stephen Carey in front spot gets it down. Goods has it turned away by Scotty West. His left foot flicked on there by Darcy. Can't get it away. Dent strong and hard at it. The Dogs quick hands on out of Powell. Johnson has a second go. Paddles it back towards Powell. They go to ground. He and Goods. Swans, Saddington to Russell. They need to keep it moving down through the centre. It's chopped off by the big man. And if you don't mind, Scotty Wine turns it back to Nicky Winmar. And that is the ball game. The big skipper stops it all in mid-action. Turns the ball back their way.
There's the handball by Jared Crouch. He'll have a sleepless night over that one. It's going to be an opportunity for the Sydney Swans to get a goal. They've had plenty of chances, the Swans.
And that's a big wall when Scotty Wine puts his hands up, isn't it? Get up over that. Winmar, he's kicked two, both in the second quarter. He needs to be a consistent three-goal man, and he is on target, Nicky.
Vietnam, 1968. And five gung-ho soldiers are about to face their biggest assignment.
Moving an elephant's operation is top secret.
Based on a true story.
You cannot put an elephant on an airplane.
About the Army's most secret weapon. Danny Glover. Dennis Leary.
Insane.
And Ray Liotta. Operation Dumbo Drop tonight.
Well, this has been a tremendous performance by the Bulldogs. Big play by Wine a moment ago. The turnover, costly. And they're home now, the Doggies. They've come from 7 goals behind at quarter time, and they're going to win by a few. Kelly gets it from Lewis. Kelly lines up and misses. And that's been the story of the last quarter for the Swans. They're 11-11 at three-quarter time. They're 12-16. They kick 1-5 in the final term, and just about all of them have been gettable.
They certainly have. They've had plenty of chances to see these Swans. There's no excuses there. They've had plenty of shots on them, plenty of shots at goal.
Well, the good work they did by beating the Saints and the Blues in Melbourne in consecutive weeks has been undone by a couple of below-average performances. The Lions were terrific last week, and the Dogs have been great today, but today they were in a winning position. This is going to be a hard defeat. There's a bad turnover, maybe. The Luck wins it back. And then loads up, but take your pick here with Darcy pushed underneath it. No free kick. Tackle was okay coming in from Schwoss. Kick by Dimantina's clever. It finds Southern, who will find Scott West. West with a heap of room on the outer side, held up by Barry. He's happy to buy time at the moment, Scott West. Credit gives him an option on the handball. He decides against that. The kick to centre half forward is a good one. Floats on over the top. Grant takes it at ground level. Right. A forward handball. Stand and deliver by Stevie Powell. It's not too bad on the left. They don't mind the Dogs running home. 3 goals now to Steve Powell. And if they thought he'd run out of petrol, he's still got plenty in the tank just now, I reckon.
Yeah, certainly has. We'll just kick 3 goals. As you said, started on the bench. Scotty West has gone very long with his kick. There it is, Chris Grant. Great hands on enormous pressure. Being tackled by one or two Sydney Swans players. Stephen Powell just over his shoulder. Had Nicky Winmar in the goal square, but still got the goal. And to be fair to say, now that probably is the ball game for the Western Bulldogs. But a terrific performance by the Doggies.
Well, the same thing happened last week with the Lions put a space in Sydney and ended up winning by well over five goals. So not only are they losing points, they're losing a bit of percentage. Creswell's kicked a set of half forward. And they just need a couple of goals to take something away from what's going to be a miserable afternoon for them. But a mighty afternoon for the Bulldogs now. Luff goes back to Russell. Russell over the top. John Stevens in his 50th strolls in, and he might have missed, has he? He's gone.
On a sound stage far, far away, a great movie was created. Then the sequel. Then a third. Then nothing. The Cold War ended. No movie. The Berlin Wall fell. Zilch. Then, like 20 years later, they decided to throw us another movie.
Well, big deal. The aliens on Third Rock are here every Sunday night. Not one Sunday here, then another Sunday 2 decades later.
Third Rock. They've got the force. We've got Dick. Tonight on 7.
After an 8-goal-2 first quarter, Sydney have kicked 5 goals, 14 since quarter time. Therein lies quite a deal of the truth in the story. They have got close enough. They've been inside 50. As Doug Hawkins has indicated, they haven't used Tony Lock as well as perhaps they might have. He only has 3 first half goals. And it's dried up for the Swans.
I just reckon the big query is Andrew Dunkley. I just can't work out. I thought he had a terrific first half. I know quite well it might have been a little bit of a mismatch, but he's the sort of player I think you have on the ground if he's right.
It's a tough position. We just saw Matthew Croft, the fullback for the Bulldogs. Dunkley, the fullback for the Swans. Two fine exponents of that position. Kelly, he's a fine leader, this man. He will never say
kick the goal.
Never surrender. The Kelly boy, all the way. Great goal, Paul. Two goals.
I just love the way he plays football, Paul Kelly. Bruce, that was just magnificent, I mean.
His biggest opponent was Wayne Schwoss for a while, wasn't it?
Have a look at this. Paul Kelly has a bounce, looks up. I just love the way he plays his football. Brownlow medalist, roll the survey. He's just a great player, Paul Kelly. What a great captain's goal.
Well, Dougie, if you can do it 3 more times in the next 3 minutes, I'll win. That's not asking a lot, is it?
He's a machine, isn't he, Bruce? He's a machine.
Well,
fantastic.
2 goals in a couple of minutes. The first time they've put 2 goals together since the first quarter, but it is too little too late. But certainly the Kelly goal we're going to remember for a while. Russell held on to by Dimatina. Swans, or Creswell's free kick. So Creswell's going to take it from about 55 metres out. Every second is vital here, but they are gone. I mean, they can't win from here. I said Collingwood were gone on Friday night, and I was right. Just Plugger flies. It's a behind, is it? It's a 3-goal game. It's been a 3-goal game for a fair bit of the second half, hasn't it? 101 to 107. 101 to 100, 14, 17 to 17, 15. Now I'm right. Working it all out. I've got to go to Dougie's school of arithmetic. I'll give Dougie and Dipper a bad name if I keep this up.
Join the team, Bruce.
I hope not. I shouldn't say that. Two of the great legends of all time.
That's not a bad school to be in, Bruce.
It's a good one. It's a lot of fun, Doug.
Exactly right.
Simon Garlick slow to get up on this one. 44 games with the Swans, Simon Garlick. And had been a player that Terry Wallace has watched since Oakley under-18s.
A big day, Wolves, I reckon, Simon Garlick.
Very good.
Been best player, been very good.
Garlick played for Richmond Reserves, not on their senior list, and was a prolific goal scorer back then. But has now turned into a very good midfielder for the Bulldogs. Here's so another one, Johnson. Yeah. And that's probably their strength. At the end of the day, they have enough players to spread the workload around throughout the middle of the ground. Johnson, Smith, another one, West.
Made it look easy, Chris Grant then. Just got in front of Duncan, used his body beautifully.
That's always the mark of a class player, is to make it look easy. There he is. 58 Brownlow medal votes over the last 3 years. A 20, a 27, and 11 last year. Averaging nearly 20 votes, it's not bad. Credilk, he desperately wants that goal. He's working hard down there. Nicks for the Swans, can't find the out. Nathan Brown takes the ball over the line and out. Sydney 101, Western Bulldogs 117. Sydney next week go to the MCG to take on Melbourne. Port Adelaide at Footy Park and then back to the SCG for Richmond. And they've got four of their last six games here at the SCG. The Dogs right on the goal line. Liberatore, Smith trying to charge through. Tackle again from Liberatore. Di Martino steps out, has a look at them, straightens up, goes for a banana of some description, but it's gone right around the back of the goal, out of bounds, on the full, free kick to the Swans.
Just thought he may have kicked his on the left foot there, Wills. He was certainly in the right spot to do that, but he tried to make it very hard for himself, and the end result was the way it was going to be, out in the full.
He obviously didn't see clearly enough what Dale Lewis had done earlier
in
the day.
That's right, Wills.
Nix keeps it low to half-back. Goods there with Garlick, Garlick and Kelly. So we're inside the final minute. 14-17 to 17-15. You wouldn't believe it, would you? At quarter time, it was 8-2-1-4. Terrific win for the Doggies. First time Terry Wallace has come to Sydney and won. It cements their position in the top six and really brings Sydney back to the field in terms of the top eight now. And with four losses at the SCG, the chances of getting a home final would be pretty small, you'd reckon, even this far from home. Smith pops it up to 4-4. Oh, what a great mark! Coming in from the side. Montgomery can do that, can't he? Well, the Mr. Cadbury man's been pretty pleased today, I reckon. That's a terrific mark. A real fly, eyes for the footy.
He had great to take, mark, mate.
Yeah.
One here last year was a real hanger,
yeah,
wasn't it?
At halfback,
and
yeah.
Game number 50, well, step up onto the stage, son.
Lovely way to finish, wouldn't it?
Wonderful.
Had a pretty quiet day to his stand.
Yep.
Didn't have a real lot of ground plays. Had the five or six touches.
And two of the milestoners, Matthew Dent and Montgomery, have had quiet ones. But
yep.
Matthew Croft, game number 100, been very good on lock at fullback.
No doubt.
Well, this will top off a terrific finish for him anyway. One to remember. He's got it. Well done. Well done. So the moment's not lost on his teammates either. On a day for him, 26 years of age, he too a late starter like John Stevens, for different reasons, but that's a terrific mark.
Yeah, great mark. Here's Rowan Smith, been a very dangerous play up in the forward line here for the Western Bulldogs. Here's Brett Montgomery, up the top he goes over Nicky Grimbar, one grabber. Terrific mark by him, and the good thing about the Western Bulldogs, they've had 10 goal kickers now, and that's going back to 4 or 5 weeks ago where they did share the ball around and kick those 18, 19 goals. It's good to see all those goal kickers.
Well, their last eight matches, they've won six now, the Bulldogs. One draw and one defeat. That's a pretty good record. Just one loss in 2 months of footy. That's the sort of stuff that puts you into a good position at the end of the year. And I think they're a real chance this season. They've got to be one of the best 3 or 4 hopes. And Montgomery's taken a mark right on the siren. But the umpire's not going to play it.
Yes, he has, Bruce.
I thought he took it before the siren, didn't you?
Yeah, I'm with you. Well, he's changed his mind if he has.
No, he's going to play it.
Yep.
So, well, wouldn't this be a fairly time? In his 50th match, didn't have a lot of it earlier. There's Leo Barry and Stephen Crediuk, who, as Terry's told us 12 times today, it's his 27th birthday.
That's for his sister Laura, who told me to mention it.
Here's Montgomery. Right on 50. Loads up. It's going to be nothing. But he's had a good day. He took the big mark and kicked the goal. 14-17 the Swans. 18-15 the Doggies. A 22-point victory after trailing by 40 points at quarter time. One of the big comebacks. Certainly not quite as spectacular as Hawthorn against the Saints, but it was a beauty. Chris Grant was an important player. Richard Osborne.
Grant, how'd you do that, mate? How'd you get out of that one?
Oh, look. You know, we've been in a position before where we've been in front like that, and the other sides have come back at us, and I think, sides have had a bit of a go at us the last couple of weeks and, tipped us off, and, certainly today it was a real character building win. You know, we've got really tough games coming up against the Kangaroos and then Adelaide, so whilst Adelaide are down the bottom at the moment, they're still a very good side, so, this 3 week period was a really important time for us, and today was just great.
It was a good team win, so it's hard to pick out individuals, but Stephen Powell, wasn't he sensational?
He was great. Look, he started off the bench, and that's where our improvement's going to come from this year, is that guys come off the bench, and guys like Powley and Garlick and those sort of guys that really do jobs for us. So, Matty Robbins is into the side and a permanent fixture now, so we're going all right, Oz. We're going all right.
Thanks for your time, mate. Enjoy.
Thanks, mate.
Well done, Chris, and you too, Ozzy. Terrific win. That's a half-time score. It's 9-6-3.